is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
Free Talk Live.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. Join us on the radio waves. You can, of course, talk about absolutely anything that happens to be on your mind. That is why we call the show Free Talk Live. The we tonight includes me, Ian.
And Conan.
And Mark.
And you can join us via Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. It's Topless Tuesday here in the Keene studios of Free Talk Live. Conan and myself are participating today. Mark, the odd man out.
Yeah.
The antisocial one.
Underneath my shirt, I have on no shirt.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
So there's actually news in the world of toplessness. It's been in the news actually off and on over the last few weeks, is this Free the Nipple event that is coming up on August 23rd. There's a topless event. GoTopless.org is going to be, I guess, not sponsoring, but they're one of the groups that's behind these things nationwide and worldwide. So you can go to gotopless.org to learn more about that. But there's one specifically happening on Hampton Beach in New Hampshire that is calling itself Free the Nipple. And as of the last time I checked, they were closing in on 1,000 people saying that they were going to be attending this event. And, it's
a lot of people.
Well, it's Facebook. So
most of them are lying.
It's real easy to just click that, you know, you're going to be attending something, even if you're just want to show your support and you're not actually going to show up and show your support. And actually, they have crossed the 1,000 attendee mark at this point. 1,017 people saying they're going to attend. What will the actual count be? Yeah, maybe a few dozen. Maybe it'll be more than 1,000. It seems less than likely that as the number of attendees goes up higher on Facebook, that it will, that the actual number of attendees will be anywhere near it. But it'll be interesting to find out what happens, especially if one politician gets his way, where there's apparently a state senator who is trying to find a way for towns to ban women from going topless. Because he is just too much of a prude.
I believe that's a she.
For this? Oh, he? She? Okay, you're right. Nancy Stiles is her name.
She's, I suppose it could be a man named Nancy.
She's a Republican from Hampton Beach.
He's a Nancy. All right.
Nancy boy. Seacoast Online reporting that a week after a small group of women went topless at Hampton Beach to support the movement of Free the Nipple, I guess they got started early. The official day was August 23rd, but they did it anyway beforehand. One legislator is vowing to find a way for towns to prohibit public toplessness for women. State Senator Nancy Stiles said if she cannot find a way for municipalities to prohibit women going topless this summer, she will file legislation next year to make it so in 2016. She said she's working.
She sounds like a lot of fun at parties,
yeah,
really.
Yeah, oh yeah. Said she's working with another state representative, so she's a state senator, and she's working with a state rep also from Hampton Beach. The Free the Nipple movement is aimed to desexualize the female nipple. The movement first gained traction in 2014 with the premiere of a globally supported film with the same name. It is billed as an equality movement to empower women and to fight oppression. Free the Nipple's New Hampshire organizers, Heidi Lilly, age 54 of Guilford, and Kaya Sinclair, 23 of Danbury, they went topless.
What are the ages? 54, 23.
And okay. 23. One of them is a big lady, and the other is a young, you know, kind of thin young lady.
All right.
And they went topless on August 3rd, so about a week ago, at Hampton Beach in the area behind the seashell stage with two female supporters. The duo is planning to lead a bigger sit-in demonstration on August 23rd, although it has yet to be real clear where exactly they're going to be sitting in, because I'm pretty sure they're going to the beach. So I don't know if that really counts as a sit-in, because I imagine some people will be standing and, you know, playing volleyball and doing beachy kind of things. And having fun, because if you're not having fun, you're doing your protests wrong. It's very important to enjoy yourself at these events. Otherwise, you might want to change how you approach things. So,
well, what if it's like a school board crappy meeting where they're increasing our taxes and you're trying to get a warrant passed? Do I have to go there and have a good time?
I think you should be able to at least try to enjoy yourself at those things. Yeah.
Because right when I walk in the building, I want to start kicking things. I want to start knocking trash cans over. I want to take their flyers and I want to throw them all over the floor.
Yeah, I don't have that same experience.
That's how they make you feel. Yeah.
And by the way,
I know what they're going to do.
By the way, so. I'm missing a meeting right now.
A school board meeting.
Yeah, I think it's the first of the year, actually.
Oh, you and everybody else. It's not like anyone goes to those things.
Well, that was the argument because the last big meeting we went to, mm-hmm. one of the school board members got all huffy and puffy. It's like, well, you guys never come to these things.
Oh, ridiculous.
How are we supposed to know? You never try to change anything until this day. You know, why don't you come during the year? And it's like, yeah, I don't.
You can't do anything if you come during the year. I've been to those things. So now we're on an aside. We'll come back to toplessness. But I've been to these school board meetings, the regular ones. There was a time when I was running for school board on a yearly basis. Mm-hmm. And early on in that process, I made a habit of going to the school board meetings regularly.
And they wanted nothing to do with anything you had to say, right?
Well, I mean, I don't...
Well, first of all, they don't really give you an opportunity to talk.
They give you two chances to talk, actually. Unlike the city council, which does not give you the chance to talk during their general meetings, the school board's general meetings open with an opportunity for the public to speak, and they close with an opportunity for the public to speak.
And then they go in their little room and they discuss.
And then they do whatever they want to do. It's not like, you know, when you speak to them, you can put some sort of item on the agenda. You can speak to them and sort of give them an earful of what you have to say. They can generally choose to not respond to you at all. In fact, I don't think they're supposed to respond. I believe there was one time when I went there, actually, promoting the idea of counter-recruiting, which is where military members, such as your former military, such as yourself, Conan, could go to a school, as the military is able to do, go and, you know, set up a table wherever it is the military is allowed to set up their table, maybe in the cafeteria or wherever it is. Or in the hallway, and perform counter-recruiting. That is to give information that is counter to the propaganda that the military is giving these students.
Who, by the way, should not be allowed in the schools, period, just because of the nature of that job. It's not
absolutely.
Like, it's not like your local business coming in, your local manufacturers come in and say, hey, you know, we're going to take these kids, you know, right out of the school. We're going to have them next door in the manufacturing whatever.
And they can't
do
that. They're not allowed to do that.
But it's at least it's a safe job.
Yeah, no.
Whereas the military, it's like you don't know what you're getting into.
Only the military has the privilege of being able to go in and actually recruit.
And they're
schools.
Applauded.
Right.
Yeah.
So
it's absolutely true. I mean, there are basically when I was in high school, there was one organization that was allowed to recruit for workers, people to sign a contract once they got out of high school, and that was the military. I don't recall any instance where the grocery stores were looking for baggers or Domino's was looking for pizza drivers or McDonald's or Burger King was looking for order takers.
Which would be an awesome thing to have like a high school job fair or something.
Yeah,
like
but
that.
They don't want kids right out of high school. I mean, they want, especially when you've got older individuals with mm-hmm. job experience already to compete with.
True.
Well, that's because of the minimum wage.
Yes.
If McDonald's could hire people at a lower wage than minimum wage, if there was, say, an age delegated minimum wage, like, you know, 14-year-olds got paid less than 15-year-olds, got paid less than 16-year-olds, this sort of thing, then you would find businesses would be, they'd try to decide, you know, what really, you know, what level of maturity is worth what for them.
That's a terrible idea to have an age-delegated minimum wage.
Yeah, let's just do away with minimum wage.
I'm with you on that. There will be a minimum wage. A minimum wage. The market
not necessarily.
The market will always designate a minimum wage.
Oh, I see what you mean by the market. I got you there.
Because people will just refuse to do it.
It's possible that a 14-year-old could have more job experience than a 16-year-old who hasn't worked before, right? So that would be unfair.
When you consider any business with hot, sharp implements, machinery, and whatnot, yeah, they're not going to hire a 12-year-old and allow them in the building because that's just a lawsuit waiting to happen.
They hired me at 16 or 15. I can't remember what it was, but I worked at Burger King for a period of time. Yeah.
So we were talking about originally the idea of Free the Nipple. And they're planning an event for August 23rd, which is happening all around the world. And apparently, when officials learned the week beforehand that state law prohibits exposure of genitals but not women's breasts, some were furious. Hampton Beach Village District Marketing Director John Kane said Hampton Beach is a family resort and that Free the Nipple demonstrators should find another location if they, quote, want to prove something, unquote. Well, what exactly is unfamily about breasts anyway?
They're pretty family.
Well, how many mothers actually breastfeed these days?
I don't know. There's kind of a movement behind that, isn't there?
I don't know. I would think it's declining, but
no, I think it's going up. I would say that a kid's view of breasts probably are to some extent designed by what their parents' view of breasts are. I don't think my son, he'd probably be interested because, well, you know, boobs are interesting. but he hasn't been told boobs are bad or anything like that. So
no, he's probably had one in his mouth a few times. And we're coming up. It's Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Hey, neighbor, what are you doing digging? You had a heart attack last year.
Oh, I know. I was told no more hard labor.
Then why are you digging?
Well, I've been taking Extendovite. It's been approved to help my heart.
Extendovite? Is that a new drug?
No, not a drug. It's more like an herbal combination made from garlic and cayenne.
Herbal? How can that help?
Well, actually, we've taken herbs for thousands of years, and Extendovite is doing the job for me.
Does your doctor know about Extendovite?
Yeah, my doctor knows, and he said it seems to be working for you, so don't stop taking it. I feel great taking Extendovite. I don't want to stop.
To order, call 1-877-928-8822. That's 1-877-928-8822. Or visit our website at heartdrop.com.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Hi, this is Walt Augustinowicz. I'm the founder and CEO of ID Stronghold. By now you've heard our commercials about wallets that protect you from electronic pickpocketing. 10 years ago, I created a way to protect my own cards from prying eyes after government officials started talking about issuing a national ID card with a built-in radio chip called RFID. I felt having to broadcast my personal information was an invasion of privacy. Soon after, it was also announced that credit cards, debit cards, U.S. passports, hotel room keys, and even transit passes would all soon incorporate RFID. It was then I formed ID Stronghold to share my inventions in blocking RFID signals with the world. There are a lot of misconceptions out there today about RFID. I encourage everyone to get informed and get protected. Please go to idstronghold.com and get the facts and the wallet, sleeves, or badge holders you need to protect your personal financial data. You'll be pleasantly surprised that through our direct sales model, you won't pay more than other comparable unprotected wallets. It is as though the protection is free. Visit idstronghold.com today.
Mike Stenerson from Midas Resources. At no time in history have precious metals been more important, certainly not in my 22 years in the industry. The dollar has lost over 90% of its value in the last 60 years. No fiat currency has ever survived the government printing presses. Ours is not immune. The time is now to be proactive. 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. Anything tied to the dollar is at risk. CDs, annuities, 401ks, IRAs, stocks, bonds, you name it, so decide. Do you want to leave a legacy of wealth or debt for your family? The choice is yours. Call me at 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. That's 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. Be proactive, not reactive. Call 1-800-686-2237, extension 116.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Yeah! Hey, we're back with Free Talk Live. Of course, you can join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And you can join us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. So feel free to do that if you want to add some commentary to the issue of both toplessness, which is apparently still controversial in the United States. Although Conan and I are going topless tonight here for Topless Tuesdays, as you can see, if you
and no
want,
one cares. Yeah.
On our web. Somebody out there cares, Mark. Someone probably cares too much.
Somebody cares.
Cam.freetalklive.com is where you can go to observe the studio situation here. And then also coming up on August 23rd, if you go to gotopless.org, you'll see there's a map somewhere on that site, which will give you a listing of all the various different cities around the globe that are going to be participating in a topless equality event, much to the chagrin of a certain group of prudish government bureaucrats and elected officials. We're going to continue with that. Plus, Conan wants to talk about the proper way to get to change the system, to change the, you know, the reality that we're a part of here. And we'd kind of touched on it a little bit during our discussion about working on the school board and going to those boring meetings, and we'll get back into that discussion. But let's talk more about toplessness. First, let's talk about keeping your health in good shape without using insurance companies, right, Mark?
That's right. This fits all the criteria of Obamacare, and in the case of my family, this is less than half, and I think that for a larger family, it's going to be even larger savings for people. So this is amazing to me. It's a Liberty Health Share is there's a movement in this country in healthcare. It's a movement of people that's ready to stand up and take charge of their healthcare. It's people like you and me who are tired of paying too much for health insurance and getting too little. People who are standing up for their values and letting their conscience make decisions based on timeless principles. It's a movement that's sweeping the nation, and you need to be part of it. Liberty Health Share is leading the movement of people who are looking for an alternative to traditional health insurance. Liberty Health Share is a healthcare sharing organization of people who are sharing the cost of healthcare in an easy and efficient way. You can choose your own doctor, choose your own hospital, live out your values in healthcare, join the movement, and we can change healthcare for good. LibertyHealthShare.org. And like, I want to change the way that healthcare is distributed and paid for and these sorts of things. But frankly, this is something you can do immediately. And it's amazing. You just get a chance to talk to them. You can call them right away, 855-58-LIBERTY. So it's 855-58-LIBERTY, LibertyHealthShare.org.
I'm pretty sure this Stiles woman, Nancy Stiles, she's a state senator here in New Hampshire who is now leading the charge to make toplessness illegal for women, I guess. So she wants to discriminate against women in this way. And she is a woman who probably is jealous of the other women who have the courage to actually go topless publicly, which is what's going to happen on August 23rd. And I'm pretty sure, given that I was sitting in the room when the vote occurred for marijuana legalization here in, or was it decrim? No, one or the other. The marijuana vote this year, I think it was decrim. This woman voted against it. So this lady is no friend of freedom, from what I can tell. And yet she claims, quote, that she is, well, this isn't a quote. She claims she's a proponent of freedom of speech and expression, she said, according to Seacoast Online, but she believes families have a right to avoid what might offend them. So she claims she supports freedom of speech and freedom of expression, but not if families are offended.
Well, there was a time when I actually was looking today, and I think it was like 1907, this lady had sort of a form-fitting body stocking thing on for a bathing suit.
Oh, my.
And she had been fined for indecency.
Even though it was legally as long as it should be, right?
Yeah, it was like completely covering her.
Yeah.
Like down to her feet or whatever. And it had a little skirt, by the way. And, for whatever reason, that was just unacceptable. So, this whole argument with families is, were families offended when this lady in 1907 wore this outfit?
Some prudish family may have been offended.
Some family was offended. There's no doubt about it. So
I'm offended by people having that much clothing on.
Right. Well, whatever. There's always some kind of crazy offense.
Unless it's snowing.
I could care less what your offense is, right? Like, your offense is irrelevant
right.
and dumb.
You don't have a right to not be offended. This is like one of the basic tenets of American free speech, is that freedom of speech includes some ugly things like the KKK and, you know, hate speech and things like that. And it can also include things that are controversial, like the ability to speak by having clothes on or having clothes off. These are sort of symbolic speeches.
Which, by the way, is what the First Amendment is for. It's to protect those types of speeches, not the types of speech that everyone's okay with.
Right. And so one of the classic things that you can say about freedom of speech is that, you know, I might not like what you have to say, but I'll defend to the death your right to say it, because freedom of speech and expression is critical. Having that freedom is critical to having at least a semblance of a free society. We know that we don't have true freedom of speech here in the United States because, you know, I can't drop the F-bomb on the airwaves. But there's multiple reasons for that. There's market pressures, and then there's also the FCC that prevents it. So there are other examples of ways that speech can be curtailed. For instance, there's a variety of stories about news media journalists who are unable to protect their sources. They'll be forced to speak. And if you are being forced to speak, you don't have the freedom of speech, because freedom of speech also should include the freedom to not speak as well. And now we've got the Supreme Court decision that says you have to invoke verbally your right to be silent, which is just seems insane, but that's the decision they've made. So no one is under, at least on this show, the belief that there truly is freedom of speech, but it's still there as a principle, and to some extent that does guide a lot of court decisions. Many courts are still fairly friendly in the United States toward the idea of freedom of speech, and we'll actually talk about that a little bit more in the ballot selfie story, which is some good news. But what we've got going here now are a group of prudes who are using their personal beliefs as an excuse to infringe or attempt to infringe upon the right of another person to express themselves. That's what's going on out in Hampton. Now, they're probably going to be completely unsuccessful at stopping this. I know that they're trying to...
This is something that it makes perfectly good sense. So I was talking about what went on and what, you know, I saw this bathing suit from 1907 where this lady was wearing this form-fitting bathing suit that, you know, covered her from wrist to ankle to neck. And she got fined for that, for indecency. And, you know, somewhere from 1907 to 2013, 100 short years, we've gone from women being fined for basically a body stocking with a skirt to essentially you can wear a micro bikini on the beach, probably with a thong potentially, mm-hmm. as long as you cover up that all important areola. And, you know, like the vulva. So, I mean, you know, there are places in the United States and places in the world where you can go, where women can go topless on the beach. Men can. And it used to be men had to wear shirts at the beach, too. They were fining them for the wrong kind of bathing suits. So we've just moved along. And, you know, you can call that progress or not progress, but to suggest that this is the moment in time when the proper amount of bathing suit attire is being worn is really kind of crazy. Like, I don't know what the right amount of bathing suit material that a person should wear is.
It's up to them.
Yeah, and there should be, frankly, just different beaches if that's what people want to have. But there,
we don't have that. We got government beaches, so right. It needs to be more freedom, in my opinion. 855-450-FREE. We'll give you some more of the prudes' opinions. What are they planning on trying in the next legislative session? And you can bring up anything on Free Talk Live.
In recent years, we have witnessed the most catastrophic disasters in history. Earthquakes, hurricanes, tornadoes, typhoons, and more. Legacy Premium Food Storage will prepare you. Our great-tasting, non-GMO quality food products have a 25-year shelf life, are the most affordable on the market, and are American-made. They're perfect for hiking, camping, and road trips, too. Be prepared with the best. Go to SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. That's SurvivalFoodAlliance.com.
Serious investors and traders want to make an 81% return in 60 seconds? We can show you how using our free tool. Use the same secret algorithm professional hedge fund managers use to make billions of dollars in profits. Turn $250 into $4,903 in just 7 clicks of a mouse. Our tool is so simple, my 82-year-old grandmother can use it to make insane stock market profits. Best part, it's 100% free. Go to richmoneyrich.com. Watch the free video before the hedge funds make us take it down. Richmoneyrich.com. That's richmoneyrich.com.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth slide into a recession or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full-color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
KatieArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order. Katie offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KatieArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CatiArmor.com. Come and take it.
It's time to build your own emergency food stockpile with the industry leader, My Patriot Supply. Once you try them, you'll know why so many Americans like you have made them part of their emergency preparedness plan. Experience the My Patriot Supply difference today with this unbelievable offer. Right now, a 4-week food supply is only $99, and that includes free shipping. That's 50% off the online price. Call 800-274-3070 to claim yours. Limit 2 per caller while supplies last. This offer isn't available online, so you want to make sure and grab this opportunity to get prepared today. 800-274-3070 to get your 4-week food supply for the incredible price of only $99, and it'll be shipped to you completely free. Call 800-274-3070 right now. That's 800-274-3070 to claim yours while supplies last. Don't wait. Call today.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
We're back now with more Free Talk Live. You're welcome to join us here at 855-450-FREE. And you can join us online. Just drop by freetalklive.com. More about topless freedom. And looks like there are at least a couple of politicians in New Hampshire who are going to go to bat to try to stop it. There's the August 23rd Free the Nipple event coming up on Hampton Beach. And also, it's global. At various different locations around the world. If you want to know more about that, go to gotopless.org. You can see if it's happening near you. And if not, I'm sure the folks over at gotopless.org would appreciate you starting one near you. It's not too late to get the ball rolling on that. We still got about 2 weeks before that hits. Bitcoinist.net is the ultimate resource for Bitcoin industry news, reviews, education, and the latest in the cryptocurrency ecosystem. Their website integrates a community forum, breaking Bitcoin and digital currency news, and they also aim to cover fintech and blockchain tech news as well. Bitcoinist has sophisticated Bitcoin network statistics, a solid beginner's guide to Bitcoin, and more. The Bitcoinist platform serves the needs of everyone looking to keep up with Bitcoin and digital currencies, from beginners to experts. Head on over to bitcoinist.net.
You know, I find the most interesting thing about the one lawmaker in particular, the Nancy girl, reminds me of a study they just did, not just did, 2013, where they found that guess who looks at boobs just as much as men do?
Women.
Women. Mm. And it's very peculiar that that's the case when they women do all the fat shaming and they do all of the boob shaming and the.
I wouldn't go that far.
I don't know if they do all of the fat shaming. I've seen people, both men and women, be rude to overweight people.
I would say they really kick it in hyperdrive when it comes to, okay, you know, making a big deal about it and the depression that comes with fat shaming.
Well, I think that there's this sort of the mean girl thing in middle school and high school, and probably starts off in elementary school.
This
too.
Nancy Stiles is probably in her late 60s, yeah, early 70s.
Well, I think that what this is another phenomenon that's going on, in my opinion. If I had to assess this, and anyone's welcome to call in and critique my assessment if that's what they wish. What's obvious to me is that women should be equal to men, and men can go without a shirt, and so therefore women should be able to too. If you want to change the rules, then that's fine. Then we'll see how many people go to your beach. But I would say that Nancy probably considers breasts to be sexual and that she feels, you know, that it, in whatever way this is sort of competition or bad for her generally. And I think that this is one of the reasons that prostitution, one of the strong reasons why prostitution is still illegal. If you go around and you ask guys whether or not they want prostitution to be illegal, I think you're going to find one of two answers. Yes, or I can't answer that. My wife would kill me.
Yeah.
Like, there's two answers for that. And, you know, if I don't know what, you know, what specifically you would get from women, but I think you'd probably get an answer of yes or no. And
the no's are the ones who don't want competition. They feel like prostitution is going to undercut their ability to have, let's say, influence over their male counterparts.
Right. I mean, you would think that I'm certain, having lived on the planet in a male body for 44 years, I am certain that women have had influence over me in my life because of their sexuality.
Is that the truth? You really think that it's about the competition? They don't want...
That's my opinion.
They don't want women who are handily available out wherever they're at to...
I think it's a decent opinion. I mean, obviously they're not going to admit it.
If you want to teach your significant other a lesson, one of the ways you might do it is by being an a-hole, right? If your significant other, which they can go out and get, sexual attention, and that was paramount to them, right? Well, it doesn't work as well because for whatever reason, women have no lack of the ability,
right, it's
generally
for the female to go and get sexual attention.
Right. If two of us, a male and a female, go on a street and they go knocking on doors asking to have sex with somebody, in five doors, the woman will be inside having sex and the man will be on his way to jail. Right. Like, that's the difference of sexuality in America.
So you're saying what it really boils down to is if I get put on the couch, I get put in the doghouse,
yep,
and I'm like, you know what, screw this. I'm just going to go
hire a prostitute.
I'm just going to go hire a prostitute for however much, whatever services I get. And get what I, you know, what I need to pass out this evening. You think women are actually considering that might be a possibility that they can hold that over my head? And
I don't know. This is
my
Mark's theory, and I think it's a good theory. I mean, whether they are considering it overtly, like they realize that's what's happening.
Do you want more competition in the area that you have influence, or do you want less competition? Humans invariably answer, I want less competition.
Even though it might make us all better. If I can say, hey, look, lady, you're not really cut out to do this. I'm going to go.
Competition does make things better, right?
They are cut out for it. Everybody's cut out for it. What it would do is it would make everybody happier in the relationship.
I think it would make people better.
Because
the playing field. Yeah.
There'd be competition in that area. So, you know, whatever.
I would say that probably most women believe that it would be immoral for everyone to sell their bodies out to the highest bidder.
What about men? They don't think that?
Well, I think.
Why do women then think that that it is immoral? I mean, women aren't morally different than men.
I think there's a good
they
amount
have different
of men.
Incentives.
I think there's plenty of men who would also say the same thing, and some of them live in our town and go to these meetings.
They may very well say the same thing. There's probably a small percentage of men out there that sort of have, you know, these classic family values or whatever, and they would really, really care about this. But I think that the percentage of women is just higher, and they're not going to be necessarily coming from that moral majority standpoint. They're going to be like, I just don't want competition in this area.
Well, there's also the kind of man who wants to pander to the women who want to keep the other women down, right? So this guy, in this particular case, there's a town manager who's a man, Fred Welch. There's this woman who is Nancy Stiles. She's a state senator. And then there's another guy, Fred Rice, who's a state representative. So, you know, what do these guys really believe about toplessness? I don't know, but they're certainly siding with the women who want to stop it. And so that's, if it's true that most men are, or like the super majority of men are on board with women being topless, then these guys are clearly pandering. That's how I interpret it. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. They want to fall in good with these ladies.
Right. Well, I mean, I think that, you know, as a any kind of politician, town manager included, or high-level bureaucrat, you have a constituency. You need to make that constituency happy. In the area of prostitution, like I said, you have two answers from men, and it's the, yes, I think prostitution should be legal, and I can't answer that because my wife would kill me. So you have, you know, at that point, you're appealing to the, I can't answer that, my wife will kill me, male standpoint, and you're appealing to the women who don't want prostitution to be legal, and so therefore you're taking the low road, it is the safe way in
I think they're going to be unsuccessful at this. I think that if they put this forward for as this woman is planning to do, in fact I'll give you more about what she's planning to do, but I don't think I think that she you know, she's going to get some attention from this politically, but ultimately that this is not going to succeed in New Hampshire. And if it does,
especially in New Hampshire, go try this in New Jersey or Connecticut. It's not happening in New Hampshire.
If this happens, if it actually does go through, it'll likely be overturned later as unconstitutional anyway.
Remember, the whole purpose of this event is to get publicity and interest in the, it's a free the nipple campaign.
Right.
These ladies don't want to have a topless party on the beach. They have a campaign going. Congratulations, Nancy, Senator Nancy. You gave them all the interest and publicity that they could have possibly asked for.
It's certainly getting a conversation
started. It's like you fell into the politician trap.
Of course, she's also getting her own attention, and there's probably a good amount of voters out there who are going to vote for her next time around.
Yeah, I think that's because all the important points.
Because the type of people who vote generally are the
more likely to be prudes.
Yeah, and vote for Republicans especially. You're going to get that moral majority sort of aspect too.
She says, I think there's a time and a place for everything. Families, we want them to feel they are comfortable. She said that she's filed a request for information at the state Senate Research Office regarding what is possible under current statutes as well as what other states are doing to prevent toplessness. She's hoping there's a way for towns to enact an ordinance similar to the one in Laconia, which fines women $250 for removing their tops for the first time, $500 for a second, and $1,000 for a third. Last week, however,
but I suspect in Laconia, you're dealing with people who are at Bike Week in Laconia who don't have the time, interest, or energy to fight this in court.
Because that would be overturned as unconstitutional.
I suspect it would be
overturned. Because they got biking to do. They don't got time to sit around and...
Well, they're going home after... They come to Laconia to party for a week, and then they go home.
All right, we'll come back with more here on the Free the Nipple event. It is under attack, and to me, it makes me just want to go even more all the way over to the seacoast. More coming up.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
Would you like to use your IRA funds to buy precious metals and hold them at home? Are you wary of the stock market, paper gold, or faraway depositories? With a checkbook IRA, you may legally take custody of IRA-owned gold and silver. Visit checkbookira.com and learn how IRA owners in all 50 states have already taken control. checkbookira.com. checkbookira.com.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618. blockitpocket.com. Enhancing health and privacy.
You pick up the receiver. With your heart racing and sweat dripping from your forehead, you finally muster the courage to dial the number to call into your favorite talk radio show. It rings once, twice, and then...
Hello, it's GCN. What's your name and the state you're calling from?
Surprised you got through, you squeak out...
Jason from Minnesota.
Please hold.
As you patiently wait for your turn, you begin to daydream about being a famous talk radio host and what it would be like to have your own show.
Jason from Minnesota, you're up.
Millions of loyal listeners worldwide waiting to call and talk to you.
Caller, are you there?
Cheering crowds surround you, calling out your name.
Jason!
Going once, twice. Okay, we gotta move on to the next caller.
You blew it.
Huh? Wait, no!
Interact with the hosts you're listening to right now online at gcnlive.com. Click on the community link. Engage with other listeners. Ask questions. Start debates. Don't agree with the host? Let them know. Be a part of the community at gcnlive.com.
There are hundreds of silver products on the market today, but there's nothing like the astonishing health benefits of the multi-patented One Silver Solution. Boost your immune system at a great price with our Silver Solution Liquid, starting at $12.95 a bottle, now available in regular and extra strength. That's half the price of the leading competitors. Call 844-USILVER for your free catalog, or go to onesilversolution.com, onesilversolution.com. There is only one Silver Solution.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live. Dial toll-free to join us on the radio at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
And Conan.
And King Mark.
And, of course, you can join us online at freetalklive.com. We love Bitcoin. You can go and get your Bitcoin over at expresscoin.com. Now, once you get some Bitcoin, if you want to send some over to Free Talk Live, get the Bitcoin tip jar over at bitcoin.freetalklive.com. But if you have not yet gotten some Bitcoin, this is the way to do it. Go to expresscoin.com. You can do it with a money order or a check. And, of course, you know, it's easy to get money orders. You can go to any Walmart or Amscot or one of those check cashing places. They'll give you a money order. So it's easy to get that. And then you send it along to ExpressCoin, whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, and you can get Bitcoin. You can also get Litecoin and Dogecoin. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. And if you use coupon code FTL, you'll get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency with absolutely no transfer fee whatsoever. So what an awesome deal. It's incredible. ExpressCoin.com. They also have a smartphone app. And again, don't forget coupon code FTL. ExpressCoin.com is where you can go to get Bitcoin. Let's go to Jeff, listening in Utah. You're on Free Talk Live. Jeff, listening to KZ and you. Hey,
thanks
there.
Thanks for having me on.
Yes, go ahead.
So I'm following up on the topless topic.
Yeah.
You can hear me, right?
Yeah, we got you loud and clear.
I can't hear.
Oh, no. If you're having trouble hearing, we can...
You can hear me. Anyways, So my perspective on this, I am an engineer studying to be an engineer. I'm a motorcyclist, and I've just got an analogy for you. In motorcycling, you'll hear all the time, there's no such thing as the perfect motorcycle. And engineering is often called the art of compromise. So if you're building a motorcycle, it's like you have to say, what do we want this motorcycle to do? Is it touring? are we trying to meet performance specifications? Is it for a certain market, a price range, price point? Anyways, and so the engineers, they have to say, what do we want? What is important? And they build the machine to meet those specifications.
Mm-hmm.
Now, with the toplessness, I'm going to call that social engineering. Anything that, you know, changes society or makes society one way or the other, that's social engineering. And so what's the spec that the topless movement is trying to meet? And just what I wanted to point out.
I would say the spec they're trying to meet is he can't hear us. Thank you, Jeff, for the call tonight. I appreciate it. So I would say the spec they're trying to meet would be equality for men and women in the area of toplessness. In some areas, they already have that. Like here in New Hampshire, it's legal for men and women to be topless in public.
And what spec would the social engineer prudes be looking for? Just family values, keeping competition out of the marketplace. You know, we don't want to. So maybe I don't have the nicest set, but she does, and she just goes and she flaunts them at the beach, and I have to sit there and stare at them. I think it's so. You're talking about the whole, you know, the marketplace. I think it's more of a envy thing, because who is going to go? All right, so there's two types of people who are going to go topless at these events. You're going to have women who just are just fat, nasty women who just don't care anymore, and it's just everyone is getting an eyeful and getting red eye the next day, and you're gonna have the good lookers who got the nice sets and they're making all the other girls. That's where I was trying to go with the whole fat shaming thing. This is very similar. It's coming from the other direction though. Yeah, it's gonna make them jealous and make them envious.
I think there's a lot of envy and jealousy behind the people who are trying to stop toplessness. I mean, those people, they secretly wish they could do this. You know, maybe they secretly wish that they had the courage to go out and show their bodies off to the rest of the world. But they, you know, they don't have it for whatever reason.
And by the way, that brings it right back. Just like the prostitution being legal and being out in the marketplace, this also would be a good thing for the human race. If more people could, you know, flaunt their nice looking bodies,
and I think
it's gonna make other people be like, you know what, hey, maybe I need to go hit the gym this weekend. Oh. Maybe I need to get a tan. Maybe I need to work on these varicose veins or whatever the crap. So maybe it will create a market where people might be more interested in taking care of themselves, which I think is a good thing. Maybe.
I mean, I would say that in answer to the caller's suggestion, the social engineering, we don't have to guess what the social engineering would look like. We have the social engineering of what it would look like. It would look like France, Italy, Spain, whatever the, without all the socialism, you know, or without quite as much.
That sounds great to me.
But aren't they topless countries, though?
They are. That's what he was referring to, I think.
Right, yeah, but they also have other problems there.
Right. They have all kinds of problems, but yeah, I don't think that it would be causation versus correlation. It would be difficult to ascribe most of the problems that people would point out in Spain, France, and Italy.
To toplessness. Yeah, it sure would. Let's talk to Ron. He's in North Carolina listening to Talk Radio 850.
Hey, guys.
In Raleigh. Hey, Ron.
Can you hear me all right?
We got you. Can you hear us? I guess that's the most important question. It sounds like there's something wrong with the...
Hello?
Yeah, all right. So I'm going to put Ron on hold there. I think there's definitely something screwy down at the network where I imagine some sort of switch has not been pressed. I will do my best to contact them and let them know about that. We'll try Ron back. Hopefully he can hang on. Maybe he can hear us when he's on hold. And so therefore he knows that he's now on hold. We'll come back to you. Our toll-free number is 855-453. You can also call us on Skype, which I'm pretty certain is working right now. Last week, Hampton Town Manager Fred Welch said ordinances are technically unenforceable if they contradict state law, as New Hampshire is not a home rule state. One of the bureaucrats here, or the elected politicians, suggested maybe a section of Hampton Beach should be reserved for toplessness, possibly during specific hours.
It's working now, properly now.
Look at that. Hey, it's a voice in our ears.
It's like God.
But everyone on the internet feed can hear what our board op just said. So, yeah, we're told the phones are working. Let's go and talk to Ron again. Ron, can you hear us now?
I could hear you before, but I guess you couldn't hear me, huh?
Oh, no, we could hear you just fine. Go ahead, sir.
All right. Yeah, first of all, I got a couple quick points here. First of all, when you talk about trying to figure out how a woman thinks or what motivates her to think in such a way, a lot smarter guys than you and me have been trying to figure that out for, you know, eons, and we've been unable to. So
the best bet is to talk to them.
there's still lots of kids out there, so we're not doing that bad. It's not we. The dinosaurs, they didn't do so well. We, on the other hand.
Yeah, we're hanging in there anyhow. Another point, too, is when it comes to a politician, I think you probably know this fairly well. What motivates a politician is obviously their political capital. They've got some focus groups going, and they decided they're better off, no matter how they personally feel about it, to go ahead and, you know, take this position or that position.
I don't think there's focus groups going on this one. So this is a New Hampshire state senator. The paycheck for that job is $200 every 2 years. And
well, my guess is it's politically motivated.
I would agree that it's politically motivated, but she's sticking her finger in the air, and she's guessing on what direction the wind's blowing.
All right, and another quick point, too, is there was this is my own personal experience at a nudist colony. There's a nudist colony in Southern Virginia, and they have an open house in the springtime, so me and a couple of my buddies rode up there on our motorcycles. There's an open house. So they had a car show there and stuff. Pretty cool. And they give you a tour of the place and see if you wanted to join up. Been there forever. And if you wanted to go swimming, you had to get naked. That's the only way you could use their facilities. It was a hot day, and I had no problems in stripping down to my birthday suit and getting in the pool. But you had people of all different ages, shapes, and sizes, you know, completely uninhibited. And it didn't bother me, and obviously it doesn't bother them. And I think it's probably if you want to do it, if you feel comfortable doing it, once you get, you know, past that initial, you know, feeling of being uncomfortable, it's certainly better to be swimming when you're naked. It's certainly there's nothing wrong with it. I just don't see
nothing wrong with it. Wrong
totally on board with that, Ron. Great thoughts. I appreciate hearing from you tonight. Sorry about the technical difficulty. We're going to go to Mark. He's in North Carolina, listening to Talk Radio 850 in Raleigh. Hello, Mark.
Hey, how are you?
Welcome. Go ahead.
Well, see, now this is an interesting thing. I've been to a couple of nude beaches, and I can tell you the ratio of real pretty boobies to the ones that hang down around their knees is not what you would think.
Oh, I bet it is exactly what I would think, and it isn't good.
And I can tell you there are a lot of people you will see nude that you will never be able to unsee.
Oh, who cares? I mean, get over it. People have different size bodies.
But you're not letting me finish.
Okay.
I'm saying, having said that, I think that there should always be a place where people who get offended by that can go without having to worry about being offended.
Sure, there's private beaches. They could go buy themselves a private beach and put up walls and, you know, have themselves a private good time without anybody possibly offending them. And, Mark, thanks for your call.
See,
Go ahead. You were saying. Oh, he hung up. Sorry about that. 855-450-FREE. There's more coming up here in moments. We got time enough for you. Hour number two is on the way. More on toplessness and changing the system coming up on Free Talk Live.
If worse comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
Kid, let me paint you a picture. Tuesday night, your cog belt goes bust. Who will help you get what you need fast, without the hoops, hurdles, or headaches? Granger, that's who. I love Granger. They got a wide variety of products and solutions. Granger makes it easy to get everything we need, and answers for when we're not sure what the answer is. Now, kid, let me paint you another picture. It looks like a mop, a basement bathroom, and you all over it. Get it? Got it? Good. Call clickgranger.com or stop by. Granger, for the ones who get it done.
Are you tired of commuting to a job that makes someone else rich, working harder than ever, but getting nowhere? Do you hate spending hundreds of dollars every week on daycare, having someone else raise your children? With Our Opportunities, you can start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss, work from home, and live a happier life. At Be the Boss Network, you'll find hundreds of work-from-home opportunities that you can literally start today and be earning money as soon as next week. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss. Get out of the rat race. Work from home. Go to freedom106.com right now and change your life today. That's freedom, the number 106.com. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You be the boss. Go to freedom106.com.
This is the Genesis Communications Network, GCN.
With SRN News, I'm Keith Peters in Washington. Ferguson resident Alan Ligon says the appearance of four members of the so-called Oath Keepers militia group on the streets of Ferguson overnight was provocative.
People come out in groups with guns. That's just a bad look, period. I mean, if the protesters came out here with guns, somebody else probably would have got killed last night, you know what I'm saying? And for them to just be able to come out here like that, it's just a bad look, and I think it's going to lead to more negative results happening.
Meanwhile, St. Louis County Police released surveillance video they say shows the 18-year-old suspect who was critically wounded after being shot by police had been holding a gun. Police say a 13-second clip of security camera footage shows him grabbing a handgun from his waistband. Sunday night's eruption of gunfire came after a day of peaceful protests in suburban Ferguson on the anniversary of the fatal police shooting of 18-year-old Michael Brown. Also at SRNNews.com, a U.S. official says the FBI has taken possession of Hillary Clinton's emails, a few of which have been deemed to contain classified information. The official says the FBI recovered two thumb drives containing the emails from Clinton's lawyer, David Kendall. Republican Senator Chuck Grassley says two of the emails were deemed top secret, sensitive, compartmented information. The head of the Environmental Protection Agency will visit the area contaminated by wastewater spilled from a Colorado mine. Gina McCarthy says she'll visit portions of Colorado and New Mexico on Wednesday. An EPA-led crew accidentally unleashed 3 million gallons of mine waste last week that turned a Colorado River mustard yellow and traveled downstream. David Filfrid, a council delegate with Navajo Nation, says people aren't getting the help and information they need from EPA officials.
How long are we going to continue to truck in water? Who's going to pick up the tab? Are we going to hold these people accountable? I want answers from EPA, but they're nowhere to be found.
This is SRN News.
You've been thinking about switching to solar. Don't wait much longer or you'll miss out on this year's federal tax credit. Move quickly because the tide is turning. Solar power is becoming a threat to big energy profits. In fact, some power companies are even pushing for extra fees to make up for lost revenue. Warning, you must have your solar system up and running by midnight December 31st or you'll miss out on this year's federal tax credit. Energy prices are expected to increase by as much as 40% in the near future. Go solar now with no down payment, interest, or payments for a whole year. You can afford it because we finance. Get your government money and save big every month. Big Energy is getting nervous and the door of opportunity is about to slam shut. Paying $150 a month or more on energy bills? Then call 1-800-MY-SOLAR now for a free in-home assessment. 1-800-MY-SOLAR.
My home, my savings, 1-800-MY-SOLAR.
U.S. wholesalers increased their stockpiles in June by the largest amount in more than a year, while sales crept up slightly.
The Commerce Department says wholesale stockpiles went up 0.9%, the largest monthly gain since April 2014. Sales inched up 0.1% in June, even though they declined 3.8% in the past year, largely due to cheaper oil prices. The increase in stockpiles left inventories at the wholesale level at a seasonally adjusted $586 billion, 5.4% above a year ago.
That's SRN's Jeremy Haas reporting. A judge in Iowa has upheld a warrant allowing federal agents to search the email account of an indicted Republican operative who has worked for Rand Paul, Ron Paul, and Mitch McConnell. Jesse Benton has sought to quash a warrant that orders Google to turn over the contents of his Gmail account dating back to March 2011. This is SRN News. Former Senator Joe Lieberman is taking over as head of a group that is dedicated to killing the Iranian nuclear deal.
Senator Lieberman is now the head of United Against Nuclear Iran. Lieberman, who was the 2000 Democratic Party's vice presidential nominee, released a statement that says the group has led an effort to economically isolate the Iranian regime. The work of the organization highlights the complicated politics of the Iran nuclear deal, which is scheduled to come up for a vote on Capitol Hill next month. Joe Lieberman takes the helm of United Against Nuclear Iran as other prominent Democrats are coming out in opposition to the deal. Linda Kenyon, SRN News.
President Obama wants Congress to accept the Iranian nuclear deal, but senators like Democrat Charles Schumer of New York are very opposed to it. Senator Schumer is a member of the Senate Democratic leadership. More details at srnnews.com. I'm Keith Peters in Washington.
By now you know that wireless technology like cell phones do in fact pose dangers to the health and privacy of everyone. Blockit Pocket's wide range of products are unmatched in providing the protection you deserve. No scare tactics, just common sense. Blockitpocket.com offers quality American-made options to alleviate and eliminate these invisible dangers. Learn more at Blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618. Blockitpocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
Hour number two of Free Talk Live is happening right now. Coming up, we'll talk about changing the system. What's the best way to do it? That's what Conan from Black Sheep Rising is wanting to discuss here tonight. Of course, you're welcome to join us to talk about whatever's on your mind at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've also got Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. It's Ian Conan and Mark in the studio. For those of you just tuning in, we are updating, or we had been updating you on the Free the Nipple event that is scheduled for Hampton Beach coming up. That's in New Hampshire, but it's also going on all around the world. GoTopless.org has a list of all the various different locations where they're going to be, you know, naked or half naked, I guess, people of both male and female versions. And at least in New Hampshire, it's legal. For now, there's one
state. You have to have your pants on, but you can have your top off.
Yeah, there's state senator who wants to make it illegal, or as she says, she wants to make it so that the towns can make their own decisions on this. She claims it's a fine line between an individual's right and what is allowed under state law. I would try to file something that would give towns permission to do what they needed to do. I wouldn't set anything in stone. I would give permission to municipalities.
Ooh, thank you. Thank you, Nancy.
Oh, I don't know what that is.
Elevator music.
Our board operator is piping in some music, which sometimes means that we are off the air from the network feed. I do not know if we are currently on right now. We'll continue to pretend like we are.
Which is what we do anyway.
Yeah. Conan, you are in support of the Topless Freedom event, although I imagine you're probably busy working. Do you think you're going to be able to make it out to it?
I will not. I have a hard time even making it to this event. But I do support the equality issues, and that's really what it boils down to as far as Heidi and What's-Her-Face. I think that's what they're really going for, because it's a very... the fact that people are so up in arms over just some brown tissue, and most of brown. I mean, I guess there's some pink mm-hmm. nipples out there, but it's, you know, why? What's the big deal? I mean, really?
Conan. Don't you have a family?
I do.
I do have a family. This is the first thing that you get asked in these circumstances. Do you have a young child? I do have a young child, and you know, I mean. It's just not. I don't expect it to be that big of a deal as far as he goes. I remember seeing a few odd occasions when I was a young man. I'd see a topless woman. I thought it was very, very interesting.
You know, the real tragedy of this is that there are still a lot of women who don't feel comfortable doing this. They don't feel comfortable, even though it's legal. They don't feel like they can do it. They've got a job. They've got other people who, you know, they're worried about what those people will think about them. So there's still, at least in, you know, in this area, and I think a lot of the United States, there's still a very firm social pressure against women going topless. I actually threw out the question to a local group of some activists recently, which was, hey, you know, it'd be cool if there was another event in New Hampshire, maybe one closer to home here, say in the Keene area, that we could bring the Free the Nipple event to the west side of New Hampshire as well. And it was pointed out by one of the male activists in the area, Garrett Ian, that he would not participate unless it was led by a female. And I have to agree, it doesn't make sense for a man to lead the, you know, a topless equality movement. And unfortunately, not a single one of the ladies in the area stepped up to create this. So even though
I don't think there's a huge demand for this among women.
There's 1,000 people that are saying they're going to go to the Hampton Beach event on Facebook.
How do you know that this isn't the Free the Nipple movement on Facebook? You get 1,000 people say they're going to go from all over the world. We don't have any idea how many people are going to go. Here's my guess. There won't be a dozen pair of boobs there.
I don't know.
I think you might be wrong about that.
I could be wrong.
Are you talking about female? You're talking about female?
Yeah, I've seen circumstances where it happens. It's just that, you know, I guess in my life, most of the women I meet have just no interest in this particular freedom. You only have the freedoms you'll exercise. And the reason that women tend not to have the freedom to exercise the ability to take their tops off is because most of them just don't want to.
Agreed. Yeah. That's agree. Yeah.
Whatever desire they had was socialized out of them a very long time ago.
Well, I hope you're wrong about that, Mark, because I know that, 5 years ago when Topless Tuesdays happened here publicly, we're doing it in the studio between Conan and I, but publicly there was a Topless Tuesdays event. If you search freekeen.com for it, you'll find the old photo of it. And I think there were maybe like 4 or 5 males and three or four females that participated in this. They were almost all locals. In fact, I think all the females were all locals. There were like me and a couple other, Rich Paul and another guy who were Free State Project participants on the male side. And that was just basically organized relatively quickly on a whim by Rich Paul downtown Keene. So he managed to get 3 females on a relatively short notice. I think that I sure hope that over 1,000 people saying they're attending, hundreds will actually show up, and of those hundreds, dozens hopefully will actually participate in it.
We'll see.
I guess we will.
Yeah, I gotta say, I don't think that that this is a particularly important issue to most people, and I think that it should be, right? Like, it should be a freedom, and it shouldn't be important. It should just be a freedom. No one should. People should just say, "All right, that's a pair of nipples. Fine, I can live with it." But they don't, and so therefore, some activists will have to take the heat, as it were, until such time as people stop making a big deal about it. But that's ultimately the only choice we have. You don't expect me to go over to 2 hours across the state in order to support or to stand in opposition to this. I don't care that much.
Yeah, I'll support this most definitely. I'll give kind words of encouragement, but no, this is not my fight. You know,
would you go to it if it was local? If there was one in Keene?
I'd go videotape it.
See, I don't go to events generally. If it was in Keene, I probably wouldn't take my time to do it.
Mm-hmm. But I mean, I try to fight that fight here in the area. You know, I make it a daily occurrence. I sell something every day, and I always go and meet my customers as naked as I can
really?
Be, you know, barefoot, just shorts, and I keep clean.
Yeah,
so
sure.
I mean, I'm not some hairy, not greasy guy dripping all over them, and I've always been met with warm welcomes. I mean, it's not. I don't think anyone's left my presence saying, "Oh my God, this is I'm never doing business with that guy again."
Yeah, but you could argue that it's unprofessional to show up at a job where you're topless, but if you're getting away with it, then that's great news.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I think we talked about this before. I mean, the people going to work with piercings and with tattoos, and I think it's a growing, and it's becoming more and more acceptable, to see some guy working at Walmart with a Mike Tyson face tattoo. I mean, it's no big deal. I mean, and he can work out on the floor and maybe even be the cashier and not, be pushed back to the back and hidden in the dungeon.
Yeah, there's a guy who's a FedEx driver who's got tattoos on him. So, and he's usually cranking metal out of the FedEx truck.
Usually they would make those guys cover all the way up to their wrists, right. And you know, maybe even wear or cover their ears with the little plastic covers or something. But no, it's not. That's not something we here in New Hampshire in this area have to deal with. And I think that this is going to be growing and becoming more acceptable. But like Mark said, it's not my fight. It's the women's fight. And if they feel like their freedoms are being kept from them, then they're the ones that need to step forward and make a big deal about it. I can only support them from a distance. I can't really say this is wrong or right or whatever. I have my own fights, you know, and really it really boils down to money. And the fact that they're stealing my money, and I want to keep my money, and that's really my biggest fight here on this planet Earth.
You can share your thoughts with us, 855-450-FREE. We'll keep you in the loop as this continues to develop. So you got politicians saying they want to make this illegal now, and that would be there'd be an argument from some people who are critical of this kind of activism is that, well, if you'd have just kept your shirts on, then it wouldn't have been pushed to be made illegal. You know, why don't you just keep your shirts on? And I think that you still need to exercise your rights, even if the consequence of exercising your rights is that there becomes a movement to outlaw your rights.
And that was the argument with the Robin Hooders. They're going around keeping down potential revenue, city revenue. And next thing you know, 6 months, a year later, bureaucrats are saying, oh, we've got to raise all the ticket fees. We've got to raise the fines. We've got to raise the hourly rate.
Right, so somebody, if they wanted to, could blame the Robin Hooders.
A lot of people did.
For the city trying to raise those things, which, by the way, they have not been successful in raising those things.
Nope, they haven't. So that's good news. But how do you like that? I mean,
hold that thought, Conan. We're going to come back with more Free Talk Live here in moments.
This message is for home intruders. Well, the cowards who break into people's homes to steal their hard-earned property. Criminals who shatter lives and rob people of their privacy and security. Listen very carefully. We're the home security experts at LiveWatch, and we're taking you down. Because we're letting everyone try our newest home security system for one full year in their home. To take advantage of this amazing offer, call now, 1-800-670-9259. LiveWatch has been helping protect homes for years, and we've learned the secrets that intruders like you don't want people to know. Criminals, it's time for you to be afraid, because every person who calls will be protected against cowards like you. To the criminals listening, we're taking you down. To those who want to help protect their homes, call the security experts to try the LiveWatch security system. There are no long-term contracts, and if you're not completely satisfied, you can cancel at any time. Try LiveWatch now by calling 1-800-670-9259. That's 1-800-670-9259.
Sciatica, lower back pain, hip pain, poor posture. If you suffer from any of these problems, get ready to relax. Introducing an amazing product that's been in the market for over 25 years, the Sacro Wedgie. It was invented by a football coach using a common sense osteopath technique. He created this device to help his athletes by isolating and supporting the sacrum, which is the keystone of our anatomy. This wedge-shaped bone is in the center of our hips, where a lot of pain starts. Simply relax 20 minutes daily on the amazingly simple Sacro Wedgie. Let gravity do the work, helping muscles rebalance and start releasing nerves. Sit in the sacro wedgie at the computer or while traveling to help correct posture to finally help relieve those stubborn aches and pains for only $33.95. It's made in the USA, so click the family-owned website at sacrowedgie.com, spelled S-A-C-R-O-W-E-D-G-Y.com, or call 1-800-737-9295. That's 1-800-737-9295. Relax your back pain away with the sacro wedgie.
Are you tired of commuting to a job that makes someone else rich, working harder than ever, but getting nowhere? Do you hate spending hundreds of dollars every week on daycare, having someone else raise your children? With our opportunities, you can start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss, work from home, and live a happier life. At Be The Boss Network, you'll find hundreds of work-from-home opportunities that you can literally start today and be earning money as soon as next week. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss. Get out of the rat race. Work from home. Go to freedom106.com right now and change your life today. That's freedom, the number 106.com. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You be the boss. Go to freedom106.com.
Gold isn't for you? Ted Anderson, president of Midas Resources, one of the world's premier gold and precious metal investing firms. I get it. You wouldn't buy gold if you believed that the government is doing a great job, that the Fed will stop handing out trillions of dollars like bailout candy, that Social Security would be there for you. That's not what's happening. You might even pass on gold if the stimulus package wouldn't fuel inflation, or that the dollar wouldn't lose value, or that your retirement would be secure. If all looks rosy to you, then now is not the time to buy gold. For the realist, there have never been more sobering reasons to diversify with gold. Since 2001, the U.S. dollar index has tanked 30% while gold has risen 300%. Right now, savvy investors are adding gold to their portfolios. You should too. Find out what they know. Call us and I'll send you 10 reasons why gold will do very well, free. 800-686-2237. 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live. You're welcome to join us toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online at freetalklive.com. We get a lot of features on our website, so drop on by and enjoy. By the way, we've talked about our AMP program. You go to amp.freetalklive.com, and you can get signed up, get access to the AMP-only Facebook group, where our Free Talk Live listeners have been comparing the discounts they've been getting on purse.freetalklive.com. One guy, Chris, says he saved 35% recently on a Brita water filter by using purse.freetalklive.com.
Ooh, that's very curious. I'm actually selling those on Amazon at the moment.
Maybe he bought that from you.
Maybe they were mine.
Yeah, well, but it's what Purse does is it teams you up with somebody who has credit on Amazon. So Amazon's selling things at their regular price. It's just that somebody's willing to use their Amazon credit and take a 35% hit in this case. In most cases, it's something like 20 to 25% if you've got like a day or two to wait. But Purse is amazing. It's really, in my opinion, the big game changer for Bitcoin, because most people say to themselves, what do I need an alternative currency for? Well, I've got an answer for you. Would you use an alternative currency if you could save 20, 25% on everything you buy in your life? We just did it today at my house. We're getting some more of those Sonic toothbrush topper things. So it's the toothbrush that goes on top of the little vibrating piece for your Sonic toothbrush. I highly recommend it. My teeth have never been so clean except when I've used the Sonic. So
you still using that mud stuff too?
My Magic Mud. Yep, I used it just the other night, and I was at the dentist today, and they gave me they were very impressed with how clean my mouth is. So
is your dentist your vet or veterinarian as well?
Yeah, I just use them for everything. Mortician also. What are you talking about?
Well, you were talking about the healthcare provider thing just a little while ago, and I was very curious. The insurance providers, does that cover everyone?
So, in the case of Liberty HealthShare, what that does is as I understand it, we aren't fully signed up yet. My wife is signing us up, but there's some kind of basically what amounts to a deductible, and dental isn't on that as far as I understand. So, you know, it's by no means a way out of paying for healthcare. It is just a way to share costs without all the overhead that insurance companies had. Anyway, purse.freetalklive.com if you want to save 20 to 25% on your purchases from Amazon. So sign up there and, you know, it's taken care of. Once you sign up at purse.freetalklive.com, you just fund your account with Bitcoin. You're ready to go.
You know, I would say any website you go to make purchases, look through their site and see if you can't find some discount for using alternative currency like Bitcoin. I've been to a couple of sites, made purchases, and found those hanging off to the side, 15% off if you make the transaction in Bitcoin. It's like, well, that sounds pretty nice to me. I've got PayPal and I've got the everything else, but I've got the Bitcoin as well.
You get the discount. It's worth it.
Yeah.
So, Conan, you wanted to discuss changing the system. You've had some discussions with your girlfriend about what's the right way to go about doing this stuff. We had talked briefly in the first hour of the show about the frustrations that people have going to these boring political, like the school board or city council meetings, where it seems like if you even get a chance to speak to these people, that they're not paying attention to what you're saying, that they don't really care what it is you have to say because they've already made up their mind.
And if you talk to anybody within the system, They'll be like, well, if you want to make changes, you've got to go talk to your... You've got to show up. You got to go talk to your lawmakers. You got to go talk to your representatives. You got to sit through this long, boring process. And it might be another year before we prevent you from ever being able to go topless again at the beach because, you know, these things take time. Instead of just not paying them the money, you know, just not giving them the money in the first place, and that'll fix the problem real quick. But no, you got to go through this long, lengthy process. And that's the way to do it. That's working through the system. This comes up because every year I like to present interesting warrant articles for the school system here in Keene, which I
these year are you design them, you come up with the wording for them, you take the time to go and get petition signatures to back them.
Right, I've actually got to go out into the public and I've got to say, hey, look, I want to reduce the budget by 1% or I want to reduce the budget by 5%.
Which is apparently really controversial.
And people are like, wow, that's an amazing idea. I never even thought about it. Can we do that? I'm like, well, they've never tried before, but you could do it in theory. I sure hope so. Let's go ahead and let me get your signature on this, and I'm going to take it to them in front of these yahoos next month, and they're all going to vote on it at the thing. The problem with the town hall type meetings where they actually, is SB2 or, anyways, they all get together, and the people who go to this meeting actually vote on the amendments, the articles that are going to go on to the ballot. Now, everyone gets to vote at the ballot. You know, and there's 17,000 registered voters here in Keene, but only like 100, and seriously, like 100 people go to these school board events.
Yeah, and like 70 out of the 100 are school board employees, and another 20 are their wives and husbands.
Correct, or the administrators, and so they have
the other 10 are the Free Staters.
Yeah, and what are they voting on? They're voting for increasing union wages, teacher wages, increasing the budget. You know, it's all about money, 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 money. So, yeah, everyone, those 70, they've got something at stake. They've got something to win, and there's a reason why they're there. Most people don't even know about these meetings. It's a Saturday morning. They got things to do. They don't know how to
real life.
They got a real life. They're not going to go sit in one of these
for 6 hours.
1 year was 6.5 friggin' hours, and it's hard. So, I mean, here's the big question, Conan. Are you wasting your time going around getting signatures and trying to put warrants on these things? Because here's the big argument. Last year, one of the school board members, he's like, well, you guys never come to these meetings. We never hear anything from you except on this particular day every single year. You just come out and you make a big show and you're all about this and that. Why don't you come during the yearly meetings and try to change it through the system like you're supposed to?
Well, that is changing it through the system. Precisely the day you guys go is the day they vote on funding.
Yeah.
Your issue with government school isn't distributing pencils or textbooks. Your issue is funding. You're going on the exact same right day. This guy is, you know, he's trying to distract from your point.
Well, according to him, they spent months coming up with this budget.
Of course they did.
And they're only approving it on this day, even though they have another month to actually go through it and before it actually gets onto the ballot.
They spent months figuring out how they were going to distribute the pencils and the textbooks. And if it was about pencils and textbooks, that wouldn't even be that big of a deal. What it in fact is about is, teachers that get paid more than their private school counterparts.
And administrators who get a lot more.
Yeah, and a lot more administrators, too, on the sheer number of them.
Our budget, which is, by the way, went up, I think it's $63 million right now.
Yeah.
The administrative department
which is
makes,
more than the entirety of
11% of the budget is just the administrators.
$60 million, by the way, is like twice what the city's budget is, right?
So it's like $20,000 per student. Think about that. Just roll that around in your head.
It's crazy.
Think about how much money you make during the year. Now, they're spending almost $20,000 per student per year.
That's crazy.
For what?
In Florida, it was like $7,000 a decade ago.
But I think the average, I think the U.S. average is like $16,000 per student.
Wow.
It's somewhere in that neighborhood. But yeah, it is definitely more in some areas.
And it's going to keep going up because they're constantly diagnosing kids with learning disabilities and putting them on some new drug and having them, you know, some kind of specialty, learning for them. It's not that we're talking about educating the children here. We're talking about funding the worst school and usually a given district.
All right, stand by. We'll come back with more. 855-450-FREE. Plus, looks like there's a Boston police commissioner hoping to criminalize the recording of the police. It's Free Talk Live.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC. .com.
So I say to Mark at lunch, look, you know, I keep hearing from the government that, you know, they're worried someday ISIS may get here. And I go, duh, Garland, Texas, Muhammad cartoon shooting, ISIS is already here. I'm not waiting for these people to defend me. If they don't know ISIS is here already, they got no clue, I'm taking care of myself. Guns80.com, AR-15 kits, 30-shot magazines, great prices. They've even got the Hillary special. Guns80.com, that's 844-2-GUNS80, Guns80.com.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
As if chlorine in our water weren't bad enough, now they're adding ammonia?
It's true. Some municipalities are now adding ammonia plus chlorine to your water supply. It's a disinfectant called chloramine. But with a trusted Big Berkey water filter, you can keep chloramine out of your water. New NSF EPA certified lab tests show EPA Berkey water filters remove chloramines, pharmaceuticals, BPA, pesticides, bacteria and viruses, all forms of fluoride, and much more. Big Berkey water filters are the original and most trusted on the market, the gold standard in water purification. And our filters last for years at less than 2 cents per gallon. Big Berkey, the one that's powerful enough to purify stagnant pond water. Get your Big Berkey today. Call 1-877-99-BERKEY or click BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. That's 1-877-99-BERKEY. Big Berkey Water Filters, for the love of clean water.
Serious investors and traders want to make an 81% return in 60 seconds? We can show you how using our free tool. Use the same secret algorithm professional hedge fund managers use to make billions of dollars in profits. Turn $250 into $4,903 in just 7 clicks of a mouse. Our tool is so simple, my 82-year-old grandmother can use it to make insane stock market profits. Best part, it's 100% free. Go to richmoneyrich.com. Watch the free video before the hedge funds make us take it down. Richmoneyrich.com. That's richmoneyrich.com.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us toll free, 855-453. That's 855-450-3733. It's not uncommon, as Conan has pointed out here, for people within the political system, politicians, to talk to the liberty community and shame us for not coming and participating often enough in their little political meetings and such, their city council meetings, their school board meetings. And
it's a part-time job going to all these things.
It's a large amount of responsibility. If you want
which
to just
is, which is why most of the members of these boards are, in fact, retirees
right.
who have nothing better to do except meddle.
And so they have a vote. Like, so if you were a member of the school board, Conan, do you think you'd go to the school board meetings on a regular basis?
I would, and I would vote no on everything.
Right. I mean, well, but you'd have a reason to go. You'd be one of, what, seven people or five people, whatever the size of the school board is in your given area. You'd be one of those people. You'd have a vote. But you know as well as I do, when you go, you're just supplicating. And they have a choice as to whether or not they listen to you. If you've gone to one of these and you had the same experience as I do, then you don't get listened to. The reason I don't go to these events is it feels like a waste of my time. I would go if I felt like I was being listened to and anyone cared. My message is going to be the same. It's consistent over and over again. You people claim a monopoly privilege on whatever it is that you're doing here. I don't agree with your monopoly. Please stop. And they're like, well, I can't. It's the system, and I'm stuck, and we gotta. What about the children? And all the other excuses. I can listen to those excuses 100 times, or I can listen to them once. They don't change.
Which, by the way, so that's the big argument. How do you, I mean, if you have nothing to do with the system, which I don't, Mark, you homeschool your kids, you don't have anything to do with it. Ian, you don't have the kids.
Nope.
So none of us have anything to do with this school system, and yet we're forced to pay into it. And if we have any disagreements with how the system is working, we have to go and waste our times at these meetings and try to convince them that we feel otherwise, that, hey, you know, maybe you shouldn't be spending so much, or hey, I have another argument. Since I don't have anything to do with the system that you're using my money to support, why should I have to go anyways?
So, I mean, I was not even able to convince these people to allow fairness in their system. I was not even able. I did actually go through the process of, and it's been so many years, I don't even remember exactly how I started it, but I must have sent some sort of letter to all of the school board members or something like that, because it did actually get discussed officially. They did come back with
no response,
which was, no, we're not going to allow you to have counter-recruiting people, military, former military, to come into the schools.
You also quoted case law. And they basically said, screw you and your case law. We do what we want around here.
I cited a case law from a different circuit.
It was a different circuit, right?
So they said, well, that's not our circuit.
Right. And this is the United States of America, and we've got 9 different circuits of court rulings here. And just because one court ruling circuit decided something was fair doesn't mean that it would be fair in this circuit. You know, New England's different than New York.
Right. And think about the children, Ian.
So I always wanted to kind of bring this one back around, but not bad enough to actually spend much time and effort doing it.
Because
I think
what it'd be is a waste of time and effort.
Well, but you can also make it more, I think, entertaining to watch. Because, you know, if you just go to these meetings and there's no video of what you say to these people, then yeah, you really are spinning your wheels.
The good news is they actually record this event. Now, I know where you're going. You make the event, make the activism fun. But here's the problem. If you ever watch any of the school board meetings, Ian gets up there, and what are some of the things you've suggested? Like, someone needs to quit their job, or can we give...
Oh, I don't know. Somebody made a long demo reel of all the stuff that we said.
They're hilarious, but at the same time, these are exactly the things that they'll use as ammunition against us liberty people.
Sure. Well, they'll use anything they can against us. I'm playing to the audience when I'm letting them have it, right?
As well as I am.
Yeah.
Even though I'm wanting to kick trash can barrels over and throw all their flyers over the place, how many people came and approached you last year and said, hey, look, I may not agree with, you know, what your warrants were trying to accomplish, but yet you just got railroaded and I saw it all and I feel bad for you. I mean, I know that's not, well, thanks, man. Thanks a lot. Why don't you stand up and say something, you know, while you watch me get railroaded, which is, by the way,
someone who was actually at the meeting who said this to you?
At least 6 people at the last meeting approached me afterwards in the privacy of being away from, you know, the flock.
Their friends, yeah.
And they said, hey, look, man, that was wrong. And that's exactly what happened, by the way, last year, is every single one of my warrants was amended
right. Yeah, we didn't
by the local busybody attorney who basically specializes in this every year. He looks forward to this. He is such a his nose is so far in it.
He comes specifically to these meetings so he can mess with your warrant articles.
And every basically. And every amendment, by the way, was illegal
that he made.
Well, they certainly were. Now, when we tried to take it to a higher court and get the same opinion from the courts, they said, well, no, he kind of was in his right. But no, bull. What he was doing was illegal. You cannot change the wording. You can't change the intent.
Apparently he did.
Well, he did. And not only did the courts agree with him, now there's court precedent saying that it's all right to do what he did.
That's really the problem, though, is that when you look at like the plain reading of the law says that he couldn't change these amendments to mean exactly the opposite of what they mean. But that's what he did. And then the court says, no, it's fine. Because the court interprets what's legal and illegal. These people, the guy sitting up there, the judge, he's a failed attorney. Now, attorneys are generally considered liars. As a matter of fact, where I'm from down in the South, that's what we call them. We call them paid liars. And, you know, the judge is just an attorney that couldn't make enough money being an attorney. So he goes and then acts as a judge. I mean, that's all.
So
I would agree with that.
The way I'd approach it is, you know, if you're not getting it on video, then it really is a waste of time. If you're just going in there and they're ignoring you, then why even bother with that? But if you can get it on video, then at the very least you can show other people the injustice. You can, you know, you can show them that the system doesn't work, that despite all their exhortations to come and participate in the system, it's never benefited us in any way, shape, or form, in any calculable way. And I'm talking locally. I think there are some benefits to going to Concord and testifying there. I've done that a number of times. But, you know, on the local level, these guys just, they're not interested, at least in Keene. Now, there are other places where there are more liberty-friendly people who are in town selectman roles and places like that. You might actually get listened to in a place like that. But Keene is like a kind of a status stronghold in New Hampshire. And
it really is.
It can be frustrating. So the way I would approach the, if we're going to reapproach the issue of the counter-recruiting, I'd want to bring somebody like you in, Conan, or somebody who was a former military person, dress in fatigues or whatever, dress in some sort of military uniform.
Oh, I got
uniform,
my fatigues with, right? with the arms cut off with big peace signs plastered all over them.
Well, whatever, you know, to go in there and sort of have a costume on that shows that you are a former military person, because that would get you more respect. I mean, even though it shouldn't, it'll get you more respect from the people that are watching, like, oh, well, Ian Freeman's in there. He wants to bring counter-recruiters in. He's never been in the military. Why does his opinion matter? But if it's an actual person who is in the military or was in the military.
Which, by the way, there's a bunch of us.
Considering,
you know, how many of us are in Keene, there's a nice big handful of previous militaries, veterans, you know, and all honorably discharged. So it's not like we're a bunch of riffraff.
Let's talk to John. He's in Maine. You're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind tonight, John?
Hi, good evening.
Yes,
I want to start off, I do enjoy your show.
Welcome.
I had a question for you. I'm not sure which host it was last week or maybe a few nights ago mentioned to a caller that you feel it's wrong for someone with a large quantity of drugs to be locked up.
Yeah,
you said it was a victimless crime.
I think that's Ian, and he's talking to a former police officer.
Yeah, it's clearly a victimless crime.
Well, I mean, my question is, I mean, I'm all for less regulation. Don't get me wrong.
Okay.
But what about the economic impact?
What do you mean?
You take someone who deals drugs.
Yeah.
That person that buys them can't handle them. They make the choice to use them. But let's
stand by, John. I want to talk more about it with you. I'll give you a chance to explain yourself. So hold on. We'll come back to you. It's Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
KatieArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order, Katie offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KatieArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CatiArmor.com. Come and take it.
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state in back taxes, you know they'll never stop coming after you. With bank levies, wage garnishments, they'll even seize your home or business. The good news? A government program for tax debt forgiveness. It's called the Fresh Start Initiative.
I'm Paul Sibley with U.S. Tax Shield. We can help navigate the new laws, get you protected, and resolve your tax issues permanently.
Call the experts at U.S. Tax Shield now for your free consultation and get a guaranteed quote to resolve your case. Call 800-436-6451. That's 800-436-6451.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
Planning to buy food storage? Wait a minute. Many companies try to confuse you with the number of servings they sell. It's not about the number of servings, it's about the number of calories. In emergencies, calories mean survival. Go to ReadySupplyFoods.com for a comparison of leading companies. Ready Supply Foods sells the most calories per dollar of any company. Our 23 entrees and breakfasts are delicious and full of nutritious calories. The new leader in value and quality. Go to ReadySupplyFoods.com today.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
We're back now. More Free Talk Live, where you may bring up anything you want. Still to come here tonight, Boston Police Commissioner, Boston being the same place from the Glick decision. The Glick decision is a major, I think it was Circuit Court of Appeals decision that basically said, yeah, you've got the right to record the police when they're doing their jobs in public. Well, now Boston Police Commissioner wants to make it illegal to record the police in public. Apparently, he hasn't been paying attention to what the courts have been doing recently. We'll tell you what he has to say for himself here in a little bit. Our toll-free number that allows you to bring up anything is 855-450-FREE. And don't forget to check out more of Conan over at Black Sheep Rising, which is his television show and podcast. There's an audio version as well for those of you who just don't have time to sit down and watch a couple-hour-long TV show. You can listen to it on your way to work, too.
That's right. Most of us do not have that opportunity. 2 hours is a long time, but lots of us are driving to work or, you know, working the long hours by ourselves if you're, you know, doing whatever. It's a variety, late-night variety libertarian program.
It's only once a month, so it's not hard to consume that.
We talk about everything. And if you want to follow us, blacksheeprising.org is the website. You also have the Facebook page, facebook.com/blacksheeprising.org. Go ahead and go there and subscribe. And if you want to see more of something, let us know, because I'm always happy to follow articles that that appeal to the folks.
You comment on stuff that's nationwide, international, but also you look at local issues too here in the Keene area and focus on some of the activists.
That's right. If a lot of local stuff is going on, we will pretty much cover that
in depth.
Yeah, in depth, and we'll go ahead and we'll break things down, and maybe even things that couldn't be said on this show get said on Black Sheep Rising, because we are a late night program.
That's right.
And
the rules of indecency do not apply.
That's right. And when I get angry, I will yell at the monitors, and sometimes people find that amusing.
Check it out.
Some of the people don't.
Blacksheeprising.org. Let's go back to John. He was concerned about the discussion we'd had previously about drug dealing. I had said on the air that it is a victimless crime, and you barely had begun to explain your thoughts on it, John, before we had to hit that break there. So can you go ahead with what you were going to say?
Sure. My only question is, people, we don't know what's good for us most of the time. We do things that we know is bad for us. So when someone takes drug use to such an extreme that they can no longer work, you know, it affects them, their health. What about the economic impact on the taxpayers as far as medical care, welfare, going on disability perhaps, or just having to go to the hospital and not being able to pay for it?
I think you just identified the problem. The problem is health care and welfare and all of that. If we didn't have those programs installed, then if someone was to go out and destroy themselves, there wouldn't be a safety net set up for them.
Well, there might be, but it could have been done voluntarily. It could be done by people who want to centrally give to some sort of a fund.
They're probably not going to give the best medical care to people who choose to harm their bodies with addictive drugs. But, I mean, the real important thing to point out here is when you arrest somebody for a kilo of cocaine, as we were talking about on, I think it was Saturday night, you are giving them free health care. You yeah, move them sure. out of the Obamacare situation where they're supposed to pay for insurance or be on like Liberty Health Share or something like that into a government funded health care system where not only even health care, but housing and everything else. So, I mean, that's the solution. The solution to the problem apparently today is socialism.
Yeah. I mean, My thing is, I'm all for deregulation. You know, you make your choices, you live with them, but you don't rely on the backs of the working people.
Sure. Well, you're right.
I feel like that's in a sense theft. You know,
I would agree. It is absolutely theft when the government steals money from you to force you to pay for people who you may not agree with. Force you to pay for their decisions that may have been poor decisions. You shouldn't have to pay for those things. But ultimately, that's not the drug dealer's fault. That's the government's fault. The drug dealer is just selling people the product that they want to buy. And there's a lot of products you can buy in the legal marketplace that you can abuse too.
Sugar.
Sure.
Yeah. So, I mean that doesn't mean we. Yeah, alcohol, sugar, whatever. I mean, that doesn't mean that Jim Beam should be outlawed again simply because some people can't control themselves.
Let's say I know someone had mentioned open borders in the past, you know, let people come in. You know, I'm okay with that as well, as long as they don't come here and immediately go on general assistance.
Most of them don't. They're going on health care.
They haven't actually paid their way in my opinion.
I think most often the first generations do not abuse that system. It's the second and third generations that really become part of the system, once they've gone through the government schools, then they get on on that bandwagon and take advantage of those programs.
Plus, there's a lot of evidence that I saw. I wish I had saved the headline, but I don't. I didn't. I had some numbers that showed that immigrants are, you know, they're coming in and they're actually paying into taxes, but because they're not part of the system, they actually aren't collecting the benefits from paying into the taxes. So they're paying millions of dollars in to the tax system, but they have no mechanism to actually collect it. So I think the idea that there's a bunch of people coming in here and mooching off the system, I think there's truth to some of that, but I don't think it's as true as some people believe. I mean, all the immigrants I've ever known are hardworking people who are here to make a better life for themselves. You know, maybe it's the circles I run in or whatever, but I've never met those shift plus ones.
That's right-wing conservative talking points right there. That's what they're going to fight to the death. Most first generation immigrants I've ever met were even harder working than a lot of people that I know.
They're more entrepreneurial.
Oh, you better believe it. If you go to the Home Depot, you're going to hire some Mexicans to come help you work that day because you can't find that job force out in Craigslist because they don't exist.
Mm. Even if it isn't, even if shiftless, lazy Mexicans and Central Americans come here for the benefits, the complaint that they do that is a specious complaint because you don't put out a bowl of cat food every morning and then complain that stray cats come to your door.
Right, so welfare
the person
is a
who's
problem.
Doing that is an idiot.
By the way,
welfare problem, not
well,
an immigrant
that's the problem.
Problem
we have in Maine.
The welfare problem?
We have two cities, Portland and Lewiston, who have practically set out that cat bowl and said, come to us.
Yeah. Your problem is with the politicians then.
It is. And it's killing their general assistance fund. I'm all for people who need it if they've paid in the past. But to have people come from out of the state or the country just for the benefits, I feel is wrong.
John, thanks for your sharing your thoughts tonight. Well, I appreciate it. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE.
I'd say do away with it altogether, and any kind of safety net that is provided should be privatized, and let the people who run those organizations deal with handing out the money. They're much, much better at it. So when some guy, some Yahoo who is always falling off the wagon and he's constantly breaking the rules and he's never recovering, guess what organization is going to know? Hey, that guy, he is such a lost cause. We're not even giving him money anymore. And they'll be so much better at handing out the money and making a difference. But the current system, no. I mean, there's no incentive to fix these people if they do in fact have problems.
The bureaucrats just want to hand out more money because it means a bigger budget for their department.
That's right, and they're going to be lobbying for that extra money every single year because they can't get enough because there is no incentive to actually fix the problem at the core.
Let's go to Todd. He's in Texas. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Todd.
Hey, gentlemen. Good evening.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. I actually was a caller to Free Talk Live in its infancy when you guys were in Florida.
Oh, my gosh.
Wow. Probably 10 years ago.
Wow. Well, welcome back.
Yeah, I appreciate it. I'll just jump right into this conversation. I'm listening to, was it Paul, the prior caller? The fact is we've been denied the able-bodied poor in this country an empty belly and no roof over their head. And if you've ever been homeless or ever had to struggle, there's something to be said for having to do what you have to do to put food on the table and to put a roof over your head. And, if people spent the money that they're spending on political campaigns on charity, on whatever charity they choose, and we got away with this idea that you're entitled to we're immorally denying you the experience of what happens when you won't work or when you make alcohol a priority over work. And you end up at someone else's mercy.
I wouldn't say that people are denied that experience. I mean, there are no shortage of bums in the streets who are, clearly on hard times. And but I get what you're saying. You're saying that because these systems exist, it makes
an obvious one. But there's a whole lot other ones of bums that are collecting a crazy check from the Social Security Administration.
Oh yeah. Oh, absolutely.
And getting diabetes treatment because they're alcoholics, and we allow that with an over-generous welfare.
Todd,
system. Stand
by. I'll bring you back here into hour number three, where we got plenty of time for you to share your thoughts, plus one police commissioner saying he wants to make it illegal to record the police in public. And photographyisnotacrime.com has that story. More coming up.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Geico applauds your inner road name.
A slow clap goes out to your biker alter ego. You might be mild-mannered Michael in the office, the guy known for raising his hand in meetings, but out on the open road, it's Motor Mike. Geico supports you and your bike, Motor Mike, because beyond cars, Geico insures motorcycles, those glorious vroom vroom machines. With 24/7 customer service and great rates, the only thing you'll be raising from now on is a heck of a good time. So head out on the highway and make that road yours, Mike. Make it yours.
Geico Motorcycle. See how much you could save.
If you're worried about your health and you're tired of the nasty side effects of harsh drugs or antibiotics, then look no further. Supernatural Silver is the answer. Supernatural Silver is a powerful immune system enhancer that can be used every day to help keep you healthy and well with none of those nasty side effects. It's extremely safe for use internally as well as topically. And Supernatural Silver is hundreds of times more effective than colloidal or ionic silver. It is perfect for use in the sinuses, eyes, ears, and on any wound or skin issue. Supernatural Silver is also extremely effective when taken orally and can help fight off bacteria, viruses, and mold that may be overwhelming your immune system. Go to SupernaturalSilver.com. SupernaturalSilver.com and use the promo code SILVER2015 for 30% off of your entire order and give yourself and your loved ones a fighting chance with Supernatural Silver.
We are the Genesis Communications Network, GCN.
With SRN News, I'm Keith Peters in Washington. Repercussions over the shooting death of 19-year-old Christian Taylor by Officer Brad Miller at a car dealership in Arlington, Texas last Friday. Arlington Police Chief Will Johnson says Miller has been fired.
Based on a preponderance of evidence available to me and the facts revealed by the investigative team, I have decided to terminate Officer Miller with the Arlington Police Department for exercising poor judgment.
Johnson says that poor judgment caused the deadly confrontation that put him and his fellow officers in danger. Also at SRNnews.com, a spokesman for Hillary Clinton's presidential campaign says she has directed that her personal email servers she used while serving as Secretary of State be given to the Justice Department. Clinton spokesman Nick Merrill says Clinton has also directed her team to turn over a thumb drive containing copies of emails sent to and from a personal email address via that server to the Justice Department. Donald Trump appeared today at a campaign rally near Detroit, Michigan. The GOP frontrunner says the firestorm involving his exchange with Fox News personality Megyn Kelly during last week's debate hasn't hurt him with voters.
I can only go by the polls. A new poll came out, 32%. That's the highest for anybody yet. So I can only go by the polls. The people that we're dealing with and whatever's happened, it is what it is.
Trump promised that he would have a series of concrete campaign proposals for people to see in the next few weeks. A clip of surveillance video appears to show an 18-year-old critically wounded by police in Ferguson, Missouri, holding a handgun. The video was released today by St. Louis County Police. Tyrone Harris Jr. allegedly shot at an unmarked police van on Sunday night. On Wall Street, the Dow down by 212 points, the Nasdaq dropped 65, the S&P lower by 20, oil down to $43.08 a barrel. This is SRN News.
The following is not an actor, but a real-life story from Trinity Debt Management.
I had numerous credit cards, and I was struggling with paying them off.
If you're in debt and you need help, call Trinity at 1-800-758-5360 to talk to a certified counselor.
I had heard about Trinity, so I made the call. They took care of all of my credit cards, and now I am completely debt-free.
Trinity will consolidate your accounts into one easy-to-manage monthly payment, put a stop to late fees and over-limit charges, reduce your interest, and possibly improve your credit score. You'll save thousands.
The people at Trinity are very friendly. They will do whatever you need them to do in order for you to feel better about being in a very difficult place.
If your debt has you down, call Trinity at 1-800-758-5360.
My name is Ann, and I'm debt-free for keeps.
1-800-758-5360.
The Pentagon is waiting until Congress returns from the August recess to revisit the issue of closing Guantanamo.
A Pentagon spokesman says the plan to close Gitmo is very close to completion. Navy Captain Jeff Davis says the plan, which will be submitted to lawmakers as soon as September, is awaiting action by other government agencies, which must sign off on it first. President Obama had made a campaign promise to close the Guantanamo Bay facility, but opposition in Congress has stalled that effort. One of the biggest disagreements has been over where to transfer the inmates, many of whom are being held as enemy combatants. Linda Kenyon, SRN News, Washington.
The Environmental Protection Agency is taking full responsibility for the spill of mine waste that's been spreading through rivers downstream from Silverton, Colorado. In Washington, EPA Administrator Gina McCarthy apologized for the spill. The people who live near the idle mine say local officials spurned federal cleanup aid for decades. This is SRN News. The World Food Program says funding prospects for Syrian refugees in Jordan are bleak, and they are facing more food cuts. World Food Program head Ertharan Cousin says nations must come up with more cash to help contain the Syrian refugee crisis.
We need to ensure that those who have given give more. Those who haven't given invest in our programs to provide us with the capacity to support those who need our assistance.
One woman who had escaped from Syria and lives in a one-room shelter with her 8 children in Amman, Jordan, faces eviction because all her rent money goes towards food for her family. In Jordan, about half of World Food Program beneficiaries, or more than 200,000 refugees, will no longer receive food aid as of September. More details at srnnews.com. I'm Keith Peters in Washington.
So I say to Mark at lunch, look, you know, I keep hearing from the government that, you know, they're worried someday ISIS may get here. And I go, duh, Garland, Texas, Muhammad cartoon shooting, ISIS is already here. I'm not waiting for these people to defend me. If they don't know ISIS is here already, they got no clue, I'm taking care of myself. Guns80.com, AR-15 kits, 30-shot magazines, great prices. They've even got the Hillary special. Guns80.com, that's 844-2-GUNS-80, Guns80.com.
Are you excited about the World Wide Web? Do you want a place where you can share your ideas and express yourself? Well, dial up your modems and stream on down to the GCN Live Community Forum. Lots of radical features await you there.
Wow, Internet guy, I am so glad I went to the GCN Live Community Forum.
You too can discover why the World Wide Web is awesome. Just go to gcnlive.com/forum. That's gcnlive.com/forum. I'll see you in cyberspace. Friend GCN Live on Diaspora and Cross.tv.
Hey, welcome back. More Free Talk Live now as we launch into the third hour of the program. We've got plenty of time for you if you want to share your thoughts with us on whatever you'd like to discuss. Everything from drug dealing as a victimless crime to boring school board meetings and how to make them more interesting, if they're even worth attending. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Sometimes when the activists try to make meetings more interesting, it gets very controversial, like when we did the drinking game here in Keene with open containers of what appeared to be alcohol but was actually water in brown bottles. Then we got arrested for that one. Ultimately, they dropped the charges because, well, what they were doing was obviously pretty illegal. But they got away with dropping the charges and got away with arresting us because, you know, it's hard to actually sue the government when they destroy your rights. We'll come back with your calls here, 855-450-FREE. With you tonight, it's Ian.
And Conan.
And Mark.
Let's bring Todd back on the line here. Todd, you were trying to get a point out earlier, and can you just recap briefly for everybody just tuning in?
Well, mainly just about the virtue of private initiative and that you vote with your money and the things that you support, that we waste an enormous amount of money on the political process through books and campaign donations. And, you know, really, if you really care about the poor, then give to an organization that will help the poor. And let's let go of this idea that it's an entitlement when it's actually I think it's morally detrimental to the supposed beneficiaries.
I agree. You're not entitled to other people's money.
And you know what? The argument that no one's going to give is just crap. You know, they're always finding that the U.S. in particular are so good about giving, especially when something big happens. Katrina happens or 9/11 happens, and people are just, I mean, the money that
even
is...
Even outside of the country.
Yeah, the money that is accumulated is enormous. I mean, so people are going to give. When they see that there are actual problems, they're going to give with their hearts. And so this isn't, you know, the only people who don't think this is possible are the left liberals. I mean, they believe that there's no way in hell someone would...
I don't think it's all lefties. Go ahead, Todd.
Well, they're all... Don't call me a goathead. That's not nice. But there's also people that are involved in these organizations that their overhead is so much drastically less. Their employees want to be there, want to be doing... It's not a job, and you're not a bothersome client.
Some of them aren't even employees. They're volunteers. That's how much they care.
If you've ever dealt with, I mean, when I was in my 20s, we got food stamps for a little while, I don't know, 6 months or so when my firstborn was born. I didn't have any money. But I'm glad there was help there, but it doesn't have to be that just because I got that help. And you have to deal with some truly uncaring people who are, you know.
The bureaucrats.
Follow the rules and
you mean the administrators.
You're a number. You're not a person that needs help. And we've just denied... The benefits of individual liberty and living with the consequences of your actions is one of the most immoral things we've done as a society, all in the name of help someone out. And it just reminds me of your prior caller talking about doing something for someone's own good when it comes to drug laws. There's nothing more tyrannical than stuff that is done under color of law for your own good.
Oh yeah, when you see that law, any lawmaker who is trying to protect you in any way, shape, or form, run screaming because those are the worst lawmakers that are ones that are trying. And by the way, that's most of them that are actually trying to create laws for your benefit.
Todd, thanks for your call and thoughts tonight. I appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733 or Skype in at Skype username lrn.fm.
About this argument where people say, in a voluntary future where the government doesn't have these welfare programs that people wouldn't give, it turns into a conversation pretty quickly. It's like, America's the biggest giving country on the planet. Mm-hmm. And
there's evidence for that.
Yeah, there's evidence for that. People are doing better now with the social welfare programs than they were before the social welfare programs, so they must be working. So there's these two arguments.
Correlation is not causation.
Indeed, but in both cases, that's a true statement. So I'd like to go through some numbers real quick on this. So we know that welfare, that about 70 cents on every dollar, welfare dollar, goes to unaccountable government bureaucrats. 70 cents out of every dollar. And on average, these charitable programs, it's about 30 cents on every dollar. So let's just go ahead and say the government's about twice as inefficient as the marketplace in this circumstance. So that means that they could service, with half as much money, just as many people. Also, in that circumstance, everybody's going to agree there's waste. Now, a lot of people will say there's 1% fraud in welfare. They've been given that statistic from somewhere, and they're running with it. Well, there's 25% fraud inside the insurance industry, and I would suggest that private companies like insurance are probably better at ferreting out fraud than the government is. So even if we went with 25% fraud, fine, we won't go with any fraud. There's zero fraud in welfare. Everybody needs it. Well, we know that some people choose to have more children in order to get more benefits. Mm-hmm. We've all seen the stories and we all know they exist. I don't know how many people are doing this, but there are clearly some amount of people that understand that way they get money is by having more children.
I've met these people. They're horrible, horrible, horrible people.
And regardless, there's also they'll do these situations. So when they're put in a situation where they are no longer incentivized to have children to therefore get the benefits, i.e., a private system where people, then you're not going to have maybe waste or fraud, but you'll have fewer people needing less money because people that are intentionally having children or at least intentionally not stopping themselves from having more children are choosing to do something else their time.
What if one of the rules of a private organization that is helping people is, hey, if you have another kid, you're getting cut off, right?
Or, like to, or maybe they'll give them an extra $10,000 if they have a tubal ligation
or a vasectomy. Or maybe just pay for it. Maybe they'll pay, you know, maybe they got doctors on staff who are willing to donate a vasectomy every week or something like that.
I have no clue what the marketplace would provide, but I think that it's pretty clear that the marketplace would provide a more efficient system. I'd be willing to give to this because right now what I'm not willing to give to is an inefficient system that less than 50 cents on a dollar goes to the actual poor people to help them. And it's probably less than a quarter on a dollar goes to actual poor people to
help
them.
You know, I actually get stuff in the mail because I don't make a whole lot of money, and somehow they've figured this out. So they actually send me applications.
Who?
The state, the feds.
Okay.
For food stamps or for any type of assistance.
Huh.
And I mean, so they know how much, maybe it's from my tax returns in previous years. So they know who I am, and just like the previous caller says, I'm a number, and they've got to get me on their rolls because the more they can get,
your prospect,
your budgets.
Yeah.
All right, 855-450 free. You're welcome to comment on the welfare system. Boston Police Commissioner, according to photographyisnotacrime.com, which is a great website that does an awesome job of following all kinds of news stories where photographers and videographers are having their rights trampled on. And by the way, we're not talking about just professionals in the business. You can have your rights trampled on as well if you pull out a video camera and record the police in some places. And certainly Boston is one of the worst. That's where the Glick decision happened, where Simon Glick was an attorney. He observed someone being arrested on the streets of Boston. He recorded it with his smartphone and was arrested for his efforts. And ultimately, that went to court, and it went up to appeals court, and Glick won in a landmark Glick decision, as it is called. That happened in Boston, but yet still, Boston Police Commissioner William Evans whined in a recent interview with the Boston Herald about people who record the police, even going so far as to call for a new law that would criminalize the act of recording a police officer while standing within a certain distance of them. Evans told the Herald, quote, "If we can get legislation to make it fair so it protects both sides, then I'm all for it. Would I love to see a little distance? I'd love to see that," he says. And
he sounds like a real snakey.
He's an ugly, ugly man as well. I'll tell you more about this coming up here in moments. And our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. He looks like that guy from the Goonies a little bit. You know that ugly guy from the Goonies?
I love you, John. Yeah.
All right, more on the way here. You can also join us on Skype. Skype username's lrn.fm, Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
It's time to build your own emergency food stockpile with the industry leader, My Patriot Supply. Once you try them, you'll know why so many Americans like you have made them part of their emergency preparedness plan. Experience the My Patriot Supply difference today with this unbelievable offer. Right now, a 4-week food supply is only $99, and that includes free shipping. That's 50% off the online price. Call 800-274-3070 to claim yours. Limit to per caller while supplies last. This offer isn't available online, so you want to make sure and grab this opportunity to get prepared today. 800-274-3070 to get your 4-week food supply for the incredible price of only $99, and it'll be shipped to you completely free. Call 800-274-3070 right now. That's 800-274-3070 to claim yours while supplies last. Don't wait. Call today.
Thousands of people seeking home security get ripped off every day, and the home security industry wants you to believe that's your only option. They've got hordes of salesmen out there trying to scare you into signing one of their long-term contracts. You get stuck writing huge checks month after month with no way out. It's robbery by contract, and it can cost you thousands. But there's a better way to protect your home. Simply Safe Home Security. Simply Safe has no contracts. None. You'll get award-winning 24/7 protection. Security professionals watching over your home, ready to instantly send police to the rescue. For just $14.99 per month. That's less than half what most companies charge. Protect your home the smart way. Visit SimplySafeDefense.com today for an exclusive 10% offer and get a free keychain remote worth $25. Only when you go to SimplySafeDefense.com. SimplySafeDefense.com.
In the U.S. alone, a home invasion occurs every 13 seconds. On top of that, the average response time for 911 is over 15 minutes. That just won't cut it. Don't allow yourself or the important people in your life to be victims. When seconds matter, don't be caught stumbling for your firearm. Get the protection you deserve. Get yourself a hidden holster from HiddenHolster.com. It's the original hidden holster. The hidden holster is quick, easy, and convenient. It's versatile enough for the home, workplace, or virtually anywhere else you might need it. Have peace of mind with your firearm close by at all times. Go to HiddenHolster.com. That's HiddenHolster.com. If you own a firearm, you need a hidden holster. Your protection matters, and self-defense is the best defense. Go to HiddenHolster.com. That's HiddenHolster.com. The original hidden holster.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Hey, we're back with Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll-free, 855-450-FREE. The police, a lot of them don't like this whole recording thing. They don't like it when you're on the streets holding them accountable with your video camera, watching as they try to trample over people's rights. They really don't like that because they don't like it when people see what things are really like. There's the sort of the police narrative version of things where they're the embattled victims of the terrible criminals out there that are always trying to take advantage of them.
Risking their lives every single day, Ian.
Even though it's not actually as risky as, say, being a roofer.
Nope.
In fact, it's
lumberjack.
Not even in
fisherman.
The top 10 of most
farmer
risky professions. Carpenter, I believe, is also a fairly risky job compared to the police.
But they'll make it seem that way, and the people who support them will make it seem that way. The people in the news and whatnot. And the same thing with teachers and firemen, by the way.
And if the police were just out there, they're just out there arresting and investigating crimes with an actual victim.
You mean like peace officers?
Yeah, if they were actually stopping real criminals, then I would think they'd be proud of video being taken of
that. But they've got a quota, Ian, because they've got to hire a couple more guys this month. And if they don't make enough money from traffic stops or from busting under 21s for whatever, drinking, or for maybe a little weed, you know, they're not going to make the money at the end of the month.
Yeah, and so there's some things that they, I don't think any cop would mind if somebody recorded video of him daringly chasing after some man who just shot someone, right? Like if there was somebody recording that video, I highly doubt the police would be embarrassed about that.
I think most employers will find that having a camera in their place of business is a really, really, really good thing because not only does it help them from bad guys, but it also helps with their own employees, making sure that they are, you know, hey, employee, by the way, there's four cameras in this building. You never know.
No slacking off, no stealing. It's usually the employees
less
who are the ones
slacking off and less stealing.
Well, right. I mean, because it's usually the employees who are the ones stealing from.
And
the
as far
company.
As cops and police officers go, guess who the employers are really at the end of the day? And no one remembers this. I'm their friggin' employer.
That's the nice theory, Conan, but you're not signing their paychecks.
Well, but the money is being stolen from
That's
me
true.
Twice a year.
But you don't get to tell them what to do.
Well, I don't get to take that money out and say, hey, you know what? I'm not right. really happy with how the police department handled their business this year. I don't like how they shot that guy. I think he should have been arrested. He didn't have to be shot in the back of the head. You know what? I'm going to keep a couple hundred dollars this year. And why don't you fire that guy while you're at it instead of giving him a stinking raise?
The fact that you can't do those things is evidence that you are, in point of fact, not their employer.
That's right.
In any way, shape, or form. You're just a source of money to pay those people, and there's some other person who's signing those paychecks, maybe the town manager or the police chief. I'm not sure exactly where the disbursements come from.
Well, I know in our particular situation, the city council can hire and fire the chief of police.
I don't believe that's true.
I think
they can only hire and fire... we're only talking about Keene, New Hampshire now. They can only hire and fire the city manager, the city clerk, and the city attorney. It's actually the city manager who ultimately is the decider on who the police chief is going to be.
Okay.
Is my understanding. So, but they are hiring a new city manager here in Keene. So if anybody's looking for a city manager job, I hear they're going to pay real nice for this.
Oh, yeah. Because they need a higher caliber, something they've gotten used to. John McClain.
The current guy's making $130,000.
Done such a great job. $130,000 before benefits.
Yeah. Yeah.
And the mayor is already talking about a $200,000 job.
Damn.
So that they can.
I think everybody that applies for this job ought to get a letter of welcome from the Free Keene blog.
You could do that, Mark. I think that's a fine idea, though. Anyway, back to the story from Boston. This police commissioner, his name's William Evans. He whined in a recent interview with the Boston Herald, according to photographyisnotacrime.com, saying if we can get legislation to make it fair so it protects both sides, he's talking about people recording the police, then I'm all for it. Would I love to see a little distance? I'd love to see that. I'm glad Evans, writes Photography is Not a Crime's Maya Schaefer, I'm glad Evans finally admits that the public needs legal protection when they record his officers. I've needed protection from the Boston police for years as they have threatened me with false arrest, with physical removal from public buildings, and have shoved me around on many occasions. But I don't think that's what the commissioner meant.
No, Evans, I suspect it's not.
Evans also complained about camera-wielding individuals allegedly getting in police officers' faces and taunting them, mentioning a July 4th incident as one example. Although he didn't reference me by name, it was clear from the description he provided that he was referring to a video I shot. In that video, I asked Boston police officers who were not wearing their badges to comply with state laws about identifying themselves. After I began speaking with the officers from a polite distance, Boston Police Deputy Superintendent William Ridge got in my face, standing literally inches away from me in an obvious attempt to intimidate, and ordered me to leave the public sidewalk that I was legally standing on. Now, before we go on with her story, I gotta say, she's right on this. Everybody who ever complains, almost to a T, not just the police, but bureaucrats, members of the public, whoever it is, anyone who ever says, those activists are getting in our face with video cameras.
It's all about the safety issues.
Go and watch whatever the video is they're talking about. Almost every time you will watch as the bureaucrat or the member of the public who is complaining is the one who actually gets in the video cameraman's face.
Yeah.
They will close a gap. Classic example of this is the Derek Jay's victimless crime spree, the scene with the crossing guard. It was all kinds of people are upset about this. Oh, how we treated this poor crossing guard. She was the one who got up in Derek's face. She closed a 6-foot gap between them and she swipes at him with this stop sign she had in her hand. She hits him with it. But yet Derek's the bad guy for recording video of that happening.
And you know what? As far as the argument as to why this guy is even trying to come up with this law. When you have a camera and you're catching, you know, people who are supposed to be protecting us, you catch them doing bad things.
Right.
Well, wait, hey, that's ground for a lawsuit. You know what? Derek probably could have.
Probably not. It's so hard to have a suit against the state. It really is. I mean, maybe
he struck with a friggin' stop sign. I saw it. He wasn't just bumped. He was hit with a stop sign.
I think that he probably could get some kind of like $1 ruling or something like that. But the problem is that it would just make the situation worse. More people would find out that he made an old lady angry enough to hit him with a stop sign, and it would just be.
He didn't make her
worse.
Angry. She made herself angry.
I'm
not using this as an example for something that could really bring a person some money from the city. I'm talking about, you know, serious issues where someone is in their home minding their own business and they knock and they, you know, knock down the wrong door or something and end up shooting your dog and maybe even your kid or something. But no. And that can only be found out if you have a camera that you can take to court with you. And before, you know, recent years, you know, no one had cameras on their cell phones. I mean, it was, you know, now that it's more and more people are coming to the idea cops aren't really there for you. They're there for themselves, their company.
They're protecting and serving themselves. They're protecting and serving their masters in the city council and the state legislature.
Which, yeah, the lawmakers who are trying to come up with these new laws, they're the masters who are trying to protect their own. It's the thin blue line we're talking about.
Well, let's see what this guy, this police commissioner, has to say about why he wants to see restrictions on people's ability to record the police. He wants some sort of a buffer zone. We've heard this one before.
Yep.
855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Your freedoms. We'll come back with them. It's Free Talk Live, or what remains of them.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC.com.
Everyone says or does something silly once in a while, but once that embarrassing thing is on the internet, it can spread like a terrible rash. Put it to rest. Get a free expert analysis today from Reputation.com. It only takes 30 seconds. 800-831-0771. We protect your online image by helping to make sure that when people search for you or your business, they find the most current, accurate information possible. Reputation.com. Because word travels fast. Call for a free analysis today. 800-831-0771. That's 800-831-0771.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Hey neighbor, what are you doing digging? You had a heart attack last year.
Oh, I know. I was told no more hard labor.
Then why are you digging?
Well, I've been taking Extendovite. It's been approved to help my heart.
Extendovite? Is that a new drug?
No, not a drug. It's more like an herbal combination made from garlic and cayenne.
Herbal? How can that help?
Well, actually, we've taken herbs for thousands of years, and Extendovite is doing the job for me.
Does your doctor know about Extendovite?
Yeah, my doctor knows, and he said it seems to be working for you, so don't stop taking it. I feel great taking Extendovite. I don't want to stop.
To order, call 1-877-928-8822. That's 1-877-928-8822, or visit our website at heartdrop.com.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Affordable health insurance was the promise of Obamacare, but for many, the government mandate caused more problems than it solved. And I want to tell you about a truly affordable alternative, Liberty HealthShare. Liberty HealthShare bypasses doctor and hospital panels, giving you the freedom to choose. 100% coverage up to $1 million per year per occurrence, includes dental, vision, pharmacy, and holistic care. Call 1-800-714-6993. 1-800-714-6993. 1-800-714-6993 today.
Did you know that drinking pure, high-alkaline water is one of the most important factors in maintaining high energy and vibrant health? Most experts agree that the water you drink should be at a pH level of 8 or higher. AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops, available only at AlkaVision.com, combine a unique formula of only the most alkaline minerals. AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops alkalize your water, ridding the body of harmful toxins, and helps you regain health and energy. Alkalizing your water by simply adding 10 drops of AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops helps the body rid itself of acidic waste, increases oxygen content, and raises the pH of your body to healthy levels. And bacteria and viruses cannot survive in an alkaline high pH environment. Order your bottle of AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops for only $29.95 at AlkaVision.com. That's AlkaVision.com. Or call 269-409-1776. 269-409-1776. Alkalize your body. Supercharge your health at AlkaVision.com today.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Hey, we're back with Free Talk Live. We got time for you to share your thoughts with us here on Recording the Police. Those darn activists are getting in the police's face, says the commissioner, one of their commissioners, William Evans from Boston, which is one of the worst places in the United States as far as police behaving badly. The Massachusetts used to have one of the worst laws as far as, you know, restricting the media, restricting you, because you are the media now. You don't have to go through the old gatekeepers. You don't have to try to get a job in television or radio or the newspaper to be the media. You, by virtue of the fact that you have access to any blog or any YouTube channel, and those are all free. You know, if you don't have your own blog, just go to WordPress.com. They'll give you one for free. You can have your own media. You can be the media as you record video of your government officials. And the police are government officials. When you record video of them, you are performing the role of being the media, especially if you publish that video after the fact.
Oh, you better believe it. You know what? A lot of these media organizations, they get a lot of their content from the locals that are out there with the
cameras.
These days
they do.
So you see this is crazy car wreck or a train derails or there's a cop who's, you know, a little aggressive. It shows up later that night at 7, and it came from some guy with a cell phone. Because, I mean, there's only so many reporters walking around with cameras. You can't be everywhere, and they right. usually only go out whenever they're called.
Yeah, it's the guys with the cell phones and the gals with the cell phones that are getting the best footage out there because they're there mm-hmm. when it happens. And now you've got this police commissioner, William Evans, in an interview with the Boston Herald saying he wants to have some distance between those folks with the cameras and the police. And of course,
they have permission, unless they've signed a paper with us yeah. and they're following us, and we know what kind of report they're going to write later on this evening or tomorrow morning, Monday morning.
So in a video that was referenced by this police commissioner, the author of the article that we're sharing with you from Photography is Not a Crime, Maya Schaefer, she apparently was referenced by this superintendent the deputy superintendent William Ridge was the cop involved in an on-the-scene situation where he attempted to intimidate this young lady into leaving the public sidewalk that she was legally standing on. Regarding that incident, the commissioner complained and said, quote, "If the officer had an incident with that person and the person wanted our badge, of course we're going to give it. But when you're just out there for the very reason of trying to get a getcha moment, then that's irritating to us."
I'm sure it is irritating. It's probably irritating for many employees when camera systems are installed in the in their work environment at first. It's like, hey, what are you doing? Accusing us of stealing? Mm-hmm. And the one who's hollering the loudest is likely the one who's stealing the most.
Probably.
And by the way, shrinkage, that's what they call this, and when employees steal stuff, is a real issue when it comes to employment. And it affects the customer's price. It affects the other employees' paychecks. It affects all kinds of things because it goes to the bottom line, and I guess not the bottom line. It affects the overall profits and what people can expect to get paid. So, you know, these are the issues. These are just government employees that do not want to be held accountable. Ultimately,
as Maya points out here, it's not a trying to get a getcha moment when I or anyone else decides to record police officers who are actively breaking laws or violating policies. Acting as though police misconduct isn't real because of the very fact that someone recorded it makes no sense. The fact that Evans is attacking people who record police misconduct instead of trying to address police misconduct shows his real priorities.
Mm-hmm.
On top of that, the law Evans is calling for.
He's more worried about lawsuits against his organization than he is about actually keeping the people safe.
That's true.
From these monsters.
And you know the lawsuit isn't going to succeed unless you got video. If you don't have video of what the police are doing and the laws they're breaking, then no one is going to believe you.
Forget about it.
It doesn't matter.
Forget about it.
You can be the most credible person out there. You can be an upstanding member, a business owner, you know, somebody who's a very, very well-known member of a society, and you could make a claim about police misbehavior, and nobody will believe you as long as there's no video evidence of it. The judges will always take the side of the police. They can do no wrong unless there's proof of it.
But they got that video footage of that cop slapping you in the face because you were a little uppity. And that's all caught on camera.
So
I also think that I'm of the opinion that any police officer that cusses during the course of their duty is unprofessional and should be docked or something like that. That should happen immediately. And we, the people that are supposedly the employers of these folks, now I don't think that's the truth in reality, but that's what we're told. We're the only ones who can enforce this stuff. If some kind of officer above them or whatever, the union's going to try to protect these officers. It's only their employers that ultimately can make this happen. And ultimately, we really are their employers. We're forced to pay their paychecks, but individually you can't do anything. But we together are their employers.
So on top of that, the law that the police commissioner Evans is calling for is clearly unconstitutional. The Glick precedent, which involved a man arrested for recording Boston cops, established years ago that recording the police is protected by the First Amendment, and not to mention the more recent Garrick decision. You know who that is? That's the president of the Free State Project.
Ooh.
So she had a very similar decision that came out of a New Hampshire case. Evans claims he's trying to address the issue of people interfering with the police, but if that's true, then there's no reason to pass a law singling out people who are recording. There are already laws against interfering with the police. So if you are having someone who's interfering, they can arrest that person and charge them with that.
We are so intimately familiar with this argument already here in Keene with the Robin Hooders. They need their space because we are harassing them, except they've never come with criminal charges.
That's
ever.
Correct. And they can't.
Because it doesn't exist. So they're just making it up. And what is the bottom line? Why are they fighting this fight? It's because of the money. And I feel it's the same argument with this knucklehead. It's all about the money. He's worried about his own brethren getting caught on film breaking the law.
And he should be, because they are.
Because they do, on a regular basis.
So, as it points out here, by targeting those who are recording, it is clear that Evans wants to criminalize journalistic activity, not interference. If a law like the one Evans hopes to see passes, it could potentially make it illegal to record police in almost any circumstance. Anytime a police officer approached a person, it would be illegal for that person to record the interaction if the cop got close enough to them. And by the way, the police are already out there telling people to back off, right? Like, if a cop tells you to back up and you don't do it, then they can arrest you for something. They can charge you with disorderly conduct.
And by the way, this brings up real interesting questions of, what if I record all my conversation on the phone? Am I wiretapping? Or what if I've got a camera on my dash and I'm recording everything and I get pulled over by a cop? Am I illegally filming that guy, even though my vehicle is set up to do what it's doing?
If this guy gets his way, which hopefully he won't, but it just, maybe this won't go anywhere, but it does show the attitude of some of these police is that they are defiant to the end. This has nothing to the police's position have nothing to do with just doing our job or enforcing the law. Because if they were just enforcing the law, then they would respect the court's decisions that have made it clear that it's legal to record them doing
like I said
duty.
Earlier about the employer, if I was running a security team and I had five dozen employees under me and they're monitoring, I would love to have all my guys with cameras on their person, on their vests, to keep track of them.
Mm-hmm.
especially if they're out there and they're mingling with the people and they're actually, you know, maybe they have a firearm on them. I would want to have this information at my disposal. I might even put it online for everyone to see. Say, hey, this is my security team. This is how they do their
business. Full transparency.
Oh, yeah. You better believe it. Yeah. As an employer, I would want to have that. The fact that these guys are running screaming from this is a real problem in my eyes.
It's an indicator that they know they're doing the wrong thing, mm-hmm. and that they want to hide that as much as they possibly can. These guys are not out there just serving and protecting. They're out there serving their interests, and their interest is to protect their butts from liability for the actions that they're making on the streets. We'll tell you more about what's happening. You can also share your thoughts on recording the police. Maybe you're on the side of the cops on this one, or at least the ones we're talking about, because I'm sure there are some cops who support this kind of transparency. 855-450-FREE. And this is Free Talk Live. More coming up.
Attention business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business?
CEO?
MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners, so you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Serious investors and traders want to make an 81% return in 60 seconds? We can show you how using our free tool. Use the same secret algorithm professional hedge fund managers use to make billions of dollars in profits. Turn $250 into $4,903 in just 7 clicks of a mouse. Our tool is so simple, my 82-year-old grandmother can use it to make insane stock market profits. Best part, it's 100% free. Go to richmoneyrich.com. Watch the free video before the hedge funds make us take it down. Richmoneyrich.com. That's richmoneyrich.com.
KatieArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor, period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order. Katie offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KatieArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CATIArmor.com. Come and take it.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233. For the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Yes, indeed, this is Free Talk Live. We do have just a few moments remaining, just enough time for you if you want to join us here at 855-450-FREE. With you in the studio, it's Ian.
And Conan.
And Mark.
And I want to tell you about ProXPN. If you're getting online in whatever way, your smartphone, your laptop, desktop computer, ProXPN can protect you because there's probably somebody out there who wants to know what you're doing online, and some people have access to it, like your internet service provider. It's likely saving your surfing history. They can keep track of all that information unless you're using ProXPN, because ProXPN will actually encrypt your data connection. So go and get started with ProXPN for free at proxpn.com/FTL. That encryption will also prevent any criminals from sniffing out your Wi-Fi packets as well. You'll also save 50% off the regular monthly price for the lifetime of your account when you buy their annual account with code FTL50. That's FTL50. FTL like Free Talk Live, and 50 as in 50% off, bringing your price down to around $5 a month for the premium account, which gets you unlimited bandwidth, servers around the globe, as well as you can privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites. It's super handy, and you can get started for free right now at proxpn.com/FTL. When you upgrade to premium, you get a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. So really, you've got nothing to lose here except your privacy. Go and get started at proxpn.com/FTL, and don't forget promo code FTL50 for a great discount on privacy that is priceless. As we go to your calls and thoughts, we're talking about being the media, and it can be a tough role to be the media, because if you don't back down when the police are threatening to you, sometimes they'll arrest you, and then you got to go through courts and you got to find attorneys. And luckily, the ACLU is pretty darn good at taking these cases and trouncing the police time and time again. Let's go though to Dave. He is in Montana, on with us via Skype. Hello, Dave.
Hey, yo, my brother Free Talker. Salud. Hey.
Welcome, sir. Go ahead.
Hey, dude, we're talking about the First Amendment here, man. The freedom of the press. See, back in 1776, a press was a machine, man.
That's true.
We're allowed to have machines to convey communication. We were allowed to have the press. That was the only machine then that could copy what you had to say, and you could pass it around to other peoples so they could read it. And you had the proof, you had the freedom to do that. And now today we have machines called video players that could copy what's going on around you, and you could pass it around and communicate to other people what's going on around you. It's the same thing. It's a freedom of the press, and these guys ain't gonna get away with killing the freedom of the press, man.
Yeah, but before, back in the day, like you're talking about, you know, you can only talk to so many people during the day. You know, if you're doing a newspaper, there's only so many newspapers you can print. But, I mean, right now, you got the internet, and it's not just your neighbors. It's not just the people in the same state.
Right.
It's the whole stinking, it's the whole globe is going to find out. And that's what really scares them.
Yeah, of course now, because the technology just don't strengthen them. It strengthens us also, and we got to stand for when they try to tromp on it, man. We got to stand hard against this.
Right on, brother.
And by the way, the internet, it's one of them things they don't control yet, and that's why they're trying to.
Well, there's too much money. There's too much money being made off the internet. They can't mess with it, because then they're going to be messing with their own people, because their own people using the internet to make millions.
There's an idea.
Dave, good call, man. Thanks for the thoughts here tonight. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. What were you saying, Conan?
No, I'm saying that, yeah, I mean, the internet is a tool for both sides of the aisle. You know, they're using it against us.
Sure.
We're using it ourselves. You know, it is making our lives better. And some of us who spend too much time on the Facebook is making our lives a lot worse. But, I mean,
yeah,
it is a good tool. But it could also be a spear, a missile against us. You know?
You need to be vigilant about that. And there needs to be, I think, more favor on the side of the little people instead of these big bureaucracies and the police and these systems. Yeah, obviously, they should be able to have cameras too. I don't think that they should be denied that ability. But they need to have transparency about that. So the one camera bill, there was like the police body camera bill here in New Hampshire. The lady that put that forward, she's actually a Keene state representative who was caught on the streets being very, very rude to the
news
media.
Oh, that's our ward, yep, Gladys.
Gladys Johnson. She actually put in the bill for the police cameras, but the bill would restrict your access to them.
Don't you love how they don't make those things very clear? Are they packed so much into those bills that, you know, oh, of course I didn't vote for it, or of course I did vote for it, but I didn't vote for that other stuff that was in it.
You couldn't have voted for this bill and had transparency at the same time. So if you like the idea of the police having cameras and you just saw the headline of the bill, you might vote for it. But the details of the bill, of course, the devil's in the details, are that if the police have these cameras, then they keep all the footage and the public won't have any kind of right to know, right to freedom of information access to it.
But Ian, we've got the pass the bill to find out what's in it.
Right. Well, the good news in New Hampshire, at least, Conan, is it's a little easier to read some of the bills here. Not all of them, but some.
And we've got Daryl too. So I mean, he's always going through these things.
He actually got an award at the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance dinner recently. Mark was the MC of the event, and he received, I think, one of three awards for being the most or one of the top three
prolific
bill reviewers.
Right.
So he's read more bills in New Hampshire probably than more state reps have read them. Anyway, back to the story here from the Boston Globe, I believe. Well, there originally was an interview with the Boston Herald interviewed Boston Police Commissioner William Evans, and he was saying he's tired of these people with their cameras and they're recording his officers and they're getting too close. So he wants to restrict how close you can be to these officers. But as the author over at photographyisnotacrime.com, Maya Schaefer, points out, if the law like the one Evans hopes to see passes, she says it could potentially make it illegal to record the police in any circumstance.
Yeah,
anytime.
What about their dash cams? Do they have to disable their dash cams now?
Oh, no, they'll have an exemption for their own dash cams. But your dash cam, they might force you to turn it off, because anytime an officer approaches you, if this guy gets his way, it would be illegal for that person to record the interaction if the cop got close enough. But, of course, such a law would probably be struck down by the courts if it were ever passed. But maybe Evans slept through civics class. But passing a law that violates the First Amendment will only lead to lawsuits and more wasted taxpayer money.
Well, he probably doesn't have a whole lot to do anyways. This is just his, you know, regular, this is his month, you know, to just make this work. What does he do again?
He's a commissioner. I don't know what that means.
Sounds like he's in charge of something.
Yeah, I don't know what a commissioner does, honestly. I know there was a show called The Commish on television back in the 1990s.
It sounds like the head cop, like the chief of police of maybe a larger place.
It sounds like he doesn't have enough to do.
I wonder if he's appointed or elected. If you know more about Boston politics, I sure as hell don't, you're welcome to call in.
I'll tell you what, we were talking earlier about who the city council could actually fire or hire here in the city, and just three of them? That's wrong. All of these fools should have to be elected, even if it's just the people who are doing the voting.
Yeah, but the problem is then you don't know who all the people are, and nobody really, you know, if you've got too many elections, too many offices to vote for, you sort of muddle the waters with too many candidates, and people won't even know who they're voting for. So.
And that's when the town gets too big, then you lose more and more of your voting rights, and it becomes more and more automated, just like here in Keene. You know, the next thing to go will be our school voting system, where we'll lose that. The lawyer that we were talking about badmouthing, he's all in favor of it. I mean, he thinks it should just be the board members making all the decisions. These six-hour events where people come in and they give their ideas and their opinions, just a waste of time. It should all be automated.
He says, should you be up in a police officer's face and agitating them? Absolutely not. Because we've seen it through all these demonstrations. It interferes sometimes with us being able to look at the crowd and focus on what our mission is. This is actually coming from the interview with a Herald, with the Boston Herald. Mark, you were going to...
Yeah, police commissioners and police chiefs are basically the same thing.
They're
the
really?
Top cop. Hmm. Okay. The commissioner's something that's in the East, and chiefs are more likely to be in the Midwest and West, and... there are some other distinctions, perhaps, but it's still not. There's no consistency with it. It's like the definition of city and town.
Oh, isn't Commissioner Gordon in Batman? He's the head cop.
Evan said he'd support legislation dictating the space between police and videotakers. And he's not specific here as to exactly how much space he's looking for. But whatever the amount is, it's you know, unless it's right up in their own personal space, which I don't agree with getting, you know, I don't think you should get that close to somebody.
If you're breathing on the other guy, yeah, you're too close.
But if you're an arm's length away from him, I think that's fine. If you're 6 feet away, you're more than fine. But the idea of having this buffer zone is something that's come up a number of times. It's come up with the Robin Hooders here in town, which is what the cops or the parking department wants. They want this buffer zone. And those have been overturned as unconstitutional in the Supreme Court on, I believe, more than one occasion.
But this is Boston, Ian.
Well, I don't think that's going to matter here. But it's, you know, it's an indicator of what these people want. They don't want accountability. They want to be able to operate under the cover of darkness. And your cameras are the ones shining the light. So please have your cameras armed and ready. And don't hesitate to record if you get the opportunity. Check out Conan at blacksheeprising.org and us at freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Every summer we go to Canyon Woods. Love getting outside. Love the hiking. Hate the itching and irritation from poison ivy, bug bites, all the things that keep me inside. So I need something strong.
Cortisone 10 Intensive Healing is clinically proven with the strongest non-prescription itch medicine available for fast, long-lasting relief of itching and irritation with 7 moisturizers to help heal skin.
I finally have the relief I need.
Hey, Jan, check this out.
On my way.
Cortisone 10. Feel the heal.
Hi, this is Walt Augustinowicz. I'm the founder and CEO of ID Stronghold. By now you've heard our commercials about wallets that protect you from electronic pickpocketing. 10 years ago, I created a way to protect my own cards from prying eyes after government officials started talking about issuing a national ID card with a built-in radio chip called RFID. I felt having to broadcast my personal information was an invasion of privacy. Soon after, it was also announced that credit cards, debit cards, U.S. passports, hotel room keys, and even transit passes would all soon incorporate RFID. It was then I formed ID Stronghold to share my inventions in blocking RFID signals with the world. There are a lot of misconceptions out there today about RFID. I encourage everyone to get informed and get protected. Please go to idstronghold.com and get the facts and the wallet, sleeves, or badge holders you need to protect your personal financial data. You'll be pleasantly surprised that through our direct sales model, you won't pay more than other comparable unprotected wallets. It is as though the protection is free. Visit idstronghold.com today.
The home of the Dr. Dahlia Show. GCN.